Lincoln.
Come on, it's 6 o'clock. Rise and shine. Rise and shine.
It's time for Early Break. Brought to you by Gaina Trucking. Live from Lincoln, America. Here's Jake Sorensen.
Did seem kind of meh.
Husker Online, Steve Sippel.
Surprisingly good.
And longtime college football assistant coach, Bill Busch.
I want to buy a couple ducks. I'm bringing two ducks to the office.
This is Early Break.
Good morning, happy Monday to you, Steve Sippel, Jake Sorensen, Bill Busch on Early Break. The band is back together today. I was not supposed to be here, but I am. The baby
the
has not been
is
born
together.
Yet. Yes. We are happy.
Three-legged stool.
It's all back together.
You were in no way thinking you were going to be here today.
I thought there was a chance, hoping that the baby was born by now, but it's not been born yet. It's being stubborn, as babies can be sometimes.
Stubborn.
Stubborn. On its own time.
Yeah.
Yeah, her
own time. Well,
yes. You do know what you're having, right?
I do, but yes. I know somebody that thought they were having a girl once. They're having a boy, like when they went in there. How do you mess that up?
When they went in there.
Crude. I mean, yeah.
This was 3 years ago or 2 years ago. I had a friend that thought they were having a boy, and they go and it was actually a girl they were having.
How do you mess that up?
I don't know. Several ultrasounds, and still they had it wrong. So that's why I can say it right now. We think it's a she.
Okay.
But you never know. We believe it's a person. It's a baby. It's not.
It's gotten awkward.
He or he is not born. Yeah. Not awkward. Bill, glad to have you
You're
back,
fine.
Bill.
It's good to be back.
How were your travels?
The travels were incredible.
Good.
Bits of speaking what's the word like that? Professional development.
Professional development. Yes. There's a good term.
PD.
Professional development. I'm gonna start using that a lot.
A lot. Good. Every day for us is professional development. It is for me. I'm with a journalist.
What are you guys doing?
I'm with a journalist.
Oh, for God's sake.
I'm with the journalist of the year.
We have a trophy.
There's a trophy.
There's a trophy for it.
I can't wait to say that to somebody. It's professional development.
Say to Keith Mann.
There's going
to
be a lot of.
That's the guy you want to say to first with Keith Mann.
There's going
to
be a lot of professional development late in my career.
Yes.
Professional development.
Well,
I thought of Bill yesterday. It was almost like an ode to Bill at noon. I rolled into town at noon and thought, oh, okay. I don't really want to eat. I really don't want to eat anything because I don't eat much. If I want to get a pie at McDonald's. And I got I didn't get the apple. I got the strawberry cream, but it was same concept. And as I was getting, it was exactly noon, and you can verify this if you have to, on Yacht Rock, I was getting a strawberry cream pie at McDonald's, and Pablo Cruz came on.
Pablo Cruz.
Oh. He once bought me a shirt. A Pablo Cruz shirt is the coolest shirt I've ever had. Then I just messed it up. I got something on it that wouldn't come out. But I thought of you. I was like, Bill's back.
He's back. I remember getting the pot. I had to order it.
God dang it. I'm going to order another one.
I had to order
it. This is a super cool t-shirt.
We also have
Love Will Find a Way, by the way.
Yep.
It's a good song.
I know that song. It's a good song.
Yeah. Also, we have two ducks named Pablo and Cruz.
That's right.
Our
ducks are named Pablo and Cruz.
Can we get an update from Rebecca Pearson, but Rebecca, the listener who took the ducks. How are Pablo and Cruz doing if you're out there? 464-5685. It's been a year since
I've been
gone.
Ducks.
It's been a year, basically, at this point.
It's been a long time.
Yeah,
almost a year.
Before May when the ducks were brought in here.
It was the summertime. Okay. No, it was the summertime.
Was it
so
summer?
It hasn't been a year yet.
That was spring.
It was in the old complex.
The old building.
We know that. So it's been close to a year.
No, don't. Yeah. The old complex.
Oh, exactly. That gets me.
Better times.
To walk into that. Death trap. No windows.
It was a butte.
Windows at the front.
At the front.
Just not where
it was a compound. Like
it's a compound. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. The bathroom was horrendous.
I know it was.
It was horrendous.
Let's be real simple. The reason why you got those pies is because you saw the Super 70s post this weekend on Twitter. I saw you retweet that.
I did see that.
No, when it scorched your mouth. We talked about that all the time. It scorches your mouth.
It was hot. It's hot. Strawberry cream was good. Yeah. I ate it way too fast. But anyway, I thought about Bill immediately. I was like, oh yeah, he's back.
Nobody goes to McDonald's more than you. Nobody. No, every meal, I every call.
I mean, don't go
every meal.
Every morning you're there.
Every morning goes to the McDonald's. Every day.
I do it. Oh, I go every day.
Is it? Yeah. How many that's times? What I mean. That's a lot.
How many? I mean, sometimes
I'm saying in the next year I go nine times.
That's
I go
nine. For me. I'm not going nine times.
Oh, I mean, seven
McDonald's.
Times yeah. a week. Seven yeah. times a week.
That's what I mean. Yeah. But there's a lot of times, day. Though, that you go more than once a day.
Oh, for sure.
But yeah, so I'm telling you. So it's 500.
I just get coffee.
But you go 500 times a year. That's a lot. times a year. The most I'm at is nine. I'm at nine. Jake's at four, and you're at 500.
I say four to five for myself.
So, I said nine. You said 500.
Put it that way.
It is. Just do the math. That might be an understatement.
When you put it that way.
You go 500 times a year. You can imagine that. How many times you go? Oh, 500. You need one of those punch cards. Hey, once it hits 400, you get
they
freak
would,
off.
They allow him to have
they got one.
One
in Manawa, too. I mean, I go there all the time. Yeah. God, that's amazing when you think about it. You're right.
It is.
500 times. All right. From YouTube, C. Garcia says, make sure you use the McDonald's app and get those free sandwiches with all those visits yes. you have.
I don't do that.
You need the app. You could say you get a lot of free stuff.
When I've been to McDonald's a few times, that freaks me out. We'd be using the app today. I'm like, no. What is
I've
this?
I've got cards.
No, I'm like, no.
Same.
I'm, no, that's why I'm in the drive-thru. Right. That's why I'm in this drive-thru lane, just talking to a microphone and pick something up out of the window. I don't know what this app thing is.
Oh, that was old.
I got criticized. The other day, I went to Qdoba down the street here.
Yes,
just a block away. I go there often for lunch. And the
Qdoba down the street?
The person said, you still haven't got that app yet, have you? I said, I sure haven't. Because you get all sorts of discounts and perks. I'm like, nope, not doing it. I'm like, so I'm like you guys. I don't do that.
What is
stuff.
The, is it Qdoba? What is the old Taco Bell on Pioneer, 70th and Pioneer?
It's a Chipotle now.
Chipotle. You can't even do a drive-thru. You have to do the app.
Right.
You have to do the app. That freaks me out.
Me too.
That freaks me out.
Me too.
That kind of one's kind of like, huh, yeah. Uh-uh. We're better than you.
Yeah.
We're better than you.
Yeah, I went into the Chipotle, I won't name it, one time, and they said, well, we're not. It was open. They said, we're not serving. You have to have be pre-ordered.
Like, how'd you what? Respond to that?
I was like, it's odd.
just wanted to get something to eat.
Yeah.
Didn't know I had
no, this is fast food.
Yeah, this is odd. It was odd. I didn't, no fuss. Just said, okay.
I couldn't, that,
I don't,
that change world. That took place there of that, of taking place of the Taco Bell, because the Taco Bell is always rock solid. I also go to a Taco Bell, and they put me in the hospital for 3 days in Arizona. 3 days.
Whoa.
It's all right. We talked about this already.
Yeah, we did.
Yes, we did.
We did. That. 3 days.
3 days.
It was a combination. It was
ER.
It was ER. It was a combination of that, and I had another virus with it at the same time. Some sort of.
You went to the ER.
ER. 3 days. Yes.
You know, it mentions ER a lot.
It does. I like that.
I tell you to go to the ER all the time.
Go to the ER.
Go get to the ER.
Go to the ER.
Yeah. My wife texts me with anything. It's like, oh, I kind of have a headache. I'd get to the ER right away.
Let me get the ER room in a second. Let's get there right now.
We have them. Use them.
The only other idle chit chat I have was I stay off O Street after 9. It's no place for old men. No. Well, on a motorcycle. No, on a motorcycle.
Oh, okay.
Because there's racers.
Yep.
And it's wild. Or if you guys want to do this, if you don't believe me, just go out tonight. Just go out tonight. Yeah. Go out tonight at 9 o'clock or 10 and see what it's like. There's drag racing. There's guys on crotch rockets doing crazy stuff. It's no place for an old man. I just I couldn't get off there quick
enough. Is the Lincoln Police Department aware of this?
They're aware of this.
Tomfoolery going on.
It is crazy out there. I mean, I couldn't get off of it quickly enough.
So everybody knows that's the spot. Hit O Street.
Yeah.
Is it more like towards the 48th on up, higher numbers?
Good questions. Yes.
It's the stretch from like Gateway Mall to 48th or 33rd, right?
Yeah.
That's the stretch.
That's where it goes.
It comes down to 27th, though. No, it's 27th.
27th?
Oh, yeah. It was down to 27th.
Okay.
Yeah, for sure. Because it's 27th where I started getting alarmed. Right by the Quiche Restaurante, by the way. I didn't know there was a... I've lived here for 30 years. I've never seen a quiche restaurant. Have you? There's a quiche restaurant.
Like the breakfast food quiche?
I guess. Yes. I don't even know what quiche is, but it's
like an egg casserole, basically.
Yes. It's a quiche restaurant on 27th and O.
Well, to be fair, that place changes names every 5-6 months or so. So that's why you didn't know about it beforehand.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a Mexican restaurant for a long time.
And Malaysian food. There's been a lot of different places.
I'm pulling hard for that place. All the spirit of the person, like, what's going to make this place go? I think quiche. I think that's where it's going. I think that's
we need some breakfast.
No, we can't. Those guys out there riding those motorcycles are going to need a breakfast casserole. Stop on in.
Hey, what's our competitor? What's our quiche competition in town? Not. Doesn't exist. We got it covered.
They're targeting the crotch rocket.
Hey, drag racing is exhausting. Get yourself a quiche. I'm going to have to take a little break quick. Hey, guys, every timeout. Let's go get a quiche.
We got some OJ. We got Box OJ in here, too. Wait a second. That's amazing.
I need to go in this place and just do some investigating into the quiche restaurant.
You can drive by it, Bill. You go that way when you do your workout thing, right?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, you'll go by it this morning. Check it out. I want you
north
to check it out.
North side, south side?
No. North.
North.
North. Yeah.
East.
East. Yep. Yeah. Good job, Jay.
I think I know exactly where you're at.
It's linked to the hotel.
It was formerly a Malaysian restaurant, Malaysian food, which I didn't know what Malaysian food even was. Yeah. Never had a Malaysian food.
And didn't they also have pictures of Malaysian food?
Yeah.
Up on the side?
I couldn't tell what it actually was, though.
Is there a picture of a quiche?
No, there's a flag of some sort. Okay. So try to figure out what the flag is.
Has anybody been to the quiche restaurant at 27th and Hill Breakers?
There's a big parking lot for motorcycles right out front.
Parking in the back.
You can't miss it. You can't miss it.
Parking's in the back. Yeah. Quiche Restaurante. That's what it is.
Go check it out. Maybe we make a remote broadcast at Quiche Restaurante.
Okay,
we can do that.
Yeah, we can do that. So, Josh is here. Personnel report, Bill. We're doing personnel reports.
Everybody's here.
Everybody's here. Josh is here. The
gang is here.
Yeah, this is fun. It's good to have Bill back.
It is good to have
him. Target the crotch rock.
I met a spirit animal.
Oh, boy.
Oh, yeah, geez. I did.
Can you share this?
I'm in line at the airport, which I'll get into later in my Bill Strolls. Yes, I'm in line. And I'm gonna get the $10 coffee at Starbucks. I'm okay with that. So we're in line. It's pretty lined up. And there's this lady up, and she's the one taking the orders. And she is incredible. Just has a lot of zest.
Where's this?
What's that? We'll get to that later.
Okay.
We'll get to that later.
That's good.
Big city though. Anyway, so we're coming, and one lady kind of gets done. And she kind of looks at the rest of the line, kind of rolls her eyes like, she's got a lot of energy, like upset about it. I go, really? We're upset because the person's super happy is taking our coffee orders. She was phenomenal.
Did you say that? You did not say that.
Oh, yeah, I did. I said something to her. I said, really? Really? That's what I'm upset about? So when I got up there in line, we go through the deal. It's like, and there's a deal in there. And I go, hey, it says here I can give you a $1 tip or a $2 tip. She goes, well, yeah, if you want to, whatever. I go, how about if we personalize it? We upgrade this. Is the whole line listening? I gave it to her. Oh, yeah, we upgraded. We upgraded. Yeah. I gave her a $6 tip.
$6? Did you seriously?
$6 tip for a cup of coffee.
$16 coffee.
I don't care. When you meet
service
someone
was good.
When you meet someone like that.
Yeah.
It was like it's early in the morning.
Yeah.
All of a sudden it could be like, oh yeah, it's a Saturday. Yeah, whatever. Yeah. Oh yeah, my life sucks.
Yeah.
No, it didn't.
Nope.
No, it didn't.
Starbucks.
Yeah. When you meet someone like that, embrace them.
How old?
Mid-40s. Mid-40s, just happy. I mean, yeah, because everybody's just look at their faces. Everybody's kind of in line.
It's really important, I think, for a business to have that. Yeah. Seriously, it's really good for a business if I'm
Mr. Starbucks and I see her working, I'm like, we're gonna pay her more because the money she's gonna make us, it's well worth it.
Yeah.
Let's take care, because once she decides to walk out the door, you know what? I'm gonna do something else. Plus, when you work at an airport, I'd like to know somebody does that. That has to be a lot of extra work. To drive out to the airport.
Ask Robin and Sean. I wonder about that all the time.
The people that come out there is like, whoa, hang on, you guys.
Yeah.
And you can't just come rolling in.
No.
You can't go through security. You don't just come rolling in the back door. Through security. You have all these badges and different things. Yeah. And she's in there happy.
Oh, my God. That's interesting.
Yeah.
That is interesting. And that is important for a business because we've all been in business where it's not the case. We've been in business where it is the case.
Yeah.
And it does make a lot.
I'm just amazed that somebody would be upset about the energy she had.
It was. I got an eye roll.
Really? Come on.
If they know it's really embraces.
It's unnormal. It's
the first thing I said to her when I walked up. I go, you're incredible. Thank you.
Thank you for your zest.
Thank you.
Eye roll.
Yeah. And then I'm in Minneapolis. I'm going to leave. I got to get a little snack. First, it was kind of crazy. I wanted to watch the Masters. Couldn't. There was 22 TVs on all the Twins Detroit.
Oh,
couldn't get
every single TV.
Get your screw.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, screw. I don't know, Jake.
That 22 TVs. All the TVs. Is it, I was gonna, how about 15 of the 22? That'd be fine. How about 7 of the Master?
And I whip my bag around, and I knock off the pepper shaker off the other thing. Falls, bam, just smash, explodes. Pepper. All glass. And it was the pepper that you could grind. So it's like little peas.
Just grinding.
Yeah, like little peas. And they went everywhere.
And so, wow.
And my waitress was so kind to them. Anyway, she wasn't there. So I go find the bartender. I say, hey, I got air out here. Do you have it? I saw a broom right there. So I get
air.
So I get the broom right away, and I'm sweeping up, and the lady comes over. She goes, oh, no. You just go get to your flight. I'll sweep this up. I go, no, I'm the one who did it.
No, that's good people, though.
But she was just, I mean, she was amazing.
She ran into good people.
Yeah, it was, the whole trip was like that. She goes, I'll get the little dustpan now. So we got it together. See? One lady even said to me, she goes, the lady in the booth next to me, I wouldn't mind hiring you, son. He said, yeah.
There's hope for society.
There is.
There's some hope out there.
There's 100%.
I flew home happy.
Yeah.
There's people out there.
There are people. No, there's definite hope.
Yeah. And there's something else going to come up, though. Them's fighting words on Wednesday.
Oh, yeah.
It comes straight from the airport.
We heard the tease in that one. Yeah. We're going to save that for Wednesday, though. We're going to save that. By the way, before we move on, Wet Blanket says, I hear the 27th Street Key Shop has an energetic customer service staff.
Okay. That would be nice. I bet they do. They have to push the keys.
What time it opens?
Have to be pretty early. It's a breakfast casserole.
Is it for sure just breakfast?
It's mainly breakfast.
Is it
a quiche for dinner?
I think most of the time, you know, remember that though, when you're a kid and you come home at night and they're having breakfast for dinner about once every 3 months or so.
Yeah, not very often.
Not very often. All of a sudden, mom's doing French toast or something.
It was incredible.
It made you the happiest. It's like, are you kidding me?
But also not that often, though.
No, for good reason. It'd be no good if all of a sudden, once a week, you'd be like, no, come on.
No, then you don't want it.
You don't want it.
You're ruining this.
When it hits you every now and then,
oh god,
that was really good.
4 times a year, maybe?
Yeah. No, you're right. It was a rare treat. I don't even think it was once every 3 months.
Probably not.
I think it's more than that.
That's why it's
twice a year.
It was all, yeah.
Twice a year.
Let's check out the key shop sometime soon. We'll do that.
Yeah, I'll be there. There is that.
Blanket. Good to hear from you.
What blanket? Corey Lincoln says, a damn straight, Bill. Been on the road for 10 days. Those positive people you encounter make a big difference.
Oh they do. Not easy.
They do. I was standing there. I looked around. I took another. There was an issue. We were going onto the plane. And someone is just taking a little bit of too much time up there, whatever. And I just kind of looked around, and there's like 60 people standing there, and everyone's mad. There's all just this scowl on their face. And I'm like, really? Just because this lady's having a little problem with her ticket or whatever? It's like that. But the plane's not leaving.
That one's not easy.
It's not that bad. But the face on everyone, you know, and they're it's just a race to get on.
How people do it, like you did it for years, right?
It was a scramble. Every day it was a scramble in recruiting.
That's what I mean. I don't know. I don't travel that much. And when I do, I'm like, man, it wears me out. I don't know if I could do it like you did. I don't know if I could do it like AD does. Like always travel.
Every week. Several times.
Wears you out.
It's when you had to get the multiple in a day was when it got you the worst. You had to get in, do something, home visit, whatever it was, and then back out the same day.
Yeah.
That was where it was like, okay, we're in and out on the same day. That was a lot back and forth.
All right, that is a wonderful extended idle chit chat sponsored by our friends at Newton's Lawn Care. Please call or text Andrew at 402-440-6297. 50% off your first fertilizer application this spring. Was he at the house this morning, Bill?
He was not at the house this morning, but he checked in because he had some other assignments he was doing because he knows there's some rain coming. We have potential rain and hail.
Sip said that this morning.
Rain and hail.
Assignments.
Yes.
Assignment.
Big storm tonight.
9 p.m. I think you better get ready to batten down the hatches.
I think we're looking at a T-storm also about 7 a.m. for these airwaves tomorrow.
I'm just
telling
you right now, if we hit that, mushrooms grow better with thunder and lightning.
Okay, I think you'll get that tonight.
And hail would be awesome too.
Hail.
Moisture with this little heat phase, we're talking about a bonanza.
Yep.
Not many people ask for hail, but Bill would not mind it for the
I would like mushrooms. Some non-damaging hail.
Non-damaging hail.
Yes, yeah, so I'd like some pea-sized hail.
Yeah.
I want some pea-sized hail.
Pea-sized hail.
And I'd like to also get about a foot of it. I'd like to have it very thick. Yes.
A foot of hail.
Yes, because it would melt slower, and that's good for the mushrooms.
Wow. It'd be fascinating if there's a foot of hail.
That would be an interesting sight.
All right.
Thanks, Newton's Lawn Care again. 404-464-5685. Call or text as always. Sip, did you get any intel at all from the scrimmage at all?
Yeah, they had you. You're an insider.
The year.
Steve, you're an insider.
I tell you things.
People talk to you. Don't tell me no one talked to you because people talk to you.
I wish you would have got me some.
I mean, the number one thing that this show wants to hear right now.
We want
to
know intel.
It's not about the service at Starbucks. They want to know about intel. From the Husker practice, from a Husker insider.
The first scrimmage of the spring.
Now, first of all, we shouldn't even go into our phone on this. You should be able to just tell us.
No.
What have you heard?
I'm not. Now, here's the thing about this. I was going to have this speech with you. I was going to have this talk.
Okay.
I'm not really an insider anymore. When I was a beat writer, it was more. Oh, here we go. Oh, no, that's not it. Oh, here it is.
We're fine.
There was more. Of that, Bill, when you become a columnist, you don't do that stuff as much. Okay,
but what'd you hear? What's the word on the street?
This is what I heard. A lot of the key veterans were held out. First of all, Robinson, Nash, Ben Scott, Jamari Butler, Tommy Hill. So a lot of the key guys were held out. Apparently, wide receivers played well. I did hear the only thing of substance that I heard is that Dylan Rayola, the big horse, had no problems with picks, no turnover issues. And I just think that he continues to do well. But I think the three scholarship guys are pretty good. They're having good. Dante Dowdell had some nice runs. Stephon Thompson, you guys know who Stephon Thompson is?
Yeah.
He's the
new linebacker.
Linebacker from Syracuse. He had a good scrimmage. Vincent Shavers had a good scrimmage. Vincent Shavers is a freshman from Miami. The offensive line did open some holes. This is just all. It's hard to.
This is good. We want the intel.
It's really hard to get anything of substance. I can't give you like Dante Dowell ran 9 times for 32 yards. I don't think anybody has that stat except maybe a coach. Emmett Johnson ran well. Bly Hill apparently flashed. Rayola and Heinrich Harburg had touchdown passes. Surprise visitor was Christian Jones. You may recognize that name. 2025 linebacker target. I'm going to say Omaha West Side. Those are the main things.
Pretty good scoop right there.
Yeah,
good
those intel are the main things. The big thing to me was the big horse. I mean, I was telling Jake last week, the first thing I'd look at, and I will continue to call him the big horse, by the way.
Dylan Rayola, not a running back. Usually that's reserved for running backs for you. Typically it has been.
My first thing when I'd watch that scrimmage, I'd just see what the turnover situation was. If there was some that were close, was it a problem? Apparently it wasn't. So that's... From there, I mean, I just think that Dylan's good enough that as long as he's not turning it over, he's gonna make plays. Just don't turn it over. So that's that. I don't know if I heard of anything else too much. The scrimmages to me aren't as significant as maybe some years because they tackle a lot. I don't know. It is what it is. I don't like the report thing because it leaves too much to the imagination. I'll watch the
people
spring
like,
game.
People like to hear the intel.
Though. I'll watch the spring game and I'll know more. Although I should have put this somewhere in writing. Rule did say very quickly the other day, it's going to be more vanilla this year.
The spring game is? Okay.
He said it very quickly.
When does he speak next?
Saturday probably. Maybe Tuesday.
Keith Mann, check in with
Keith
us.
Keith Mann, when's
you know what?
When's Matt Rule's talk?
So there is no. So after the scrimmage Saturday, there was nothing with the media.
There's no media session.
Now that's a good question. Okay. Usually there is, but just on this Saturday, it was just they just gave the media Saturday off. That's a good question, Bill. Next week there will be. So there'll be more from the scrimmage next week than there would be this week. No, there was a scrimmage and there was no access.
Gotcha. There's access tomorrow, though, or is it today?
Access tomorrow.
Access tomorrow.
Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
for show purposes Tuesday,
Thursday, Saturday.
And it's, and you know what? You know what? Sorry. Rule will be available tomorrow, I would think. Yes. There you go. There's a report.
I just wonder if we get to a point where, even though you're optimistic about Kalen and Raiola and obviously in Harburg, is there a reason to want to have a transfer quarterback in here?
That's a good question.
Post spring. Two freshman quarterbacks and a guy that, you know, started not every game last year, but was your main starter last year. It wasn't overly effective as a quarterback.
I'm not sidestepping the question. I think Bill would agree. I'd be interested. It's got to be the right guy.
Yeah.
When you say, would they bring in a quarterback? I don't know. I mean, it takes two to tango, number one. That person would have to kind of understand the lay of the land here, right?
There'd be a lot to it. If you brought someone in, you want somebody that has played. Somebody, not someone that's like, he's been in a few games late. You have to bring someone in that's like been a starter. You can see on film that he has played. Doesn't have to be at Power Five. Doesn't have to be a group of five. No, it's group of, I know it's Power Four now.
Yeah.
Or a group of five, whatever it is.
Whatever it is, yeah.
Or it could be also FCS. Just someone that has played, started games, and has had success.
It's the question, Jake. They're not going to do a lot of portal. They're not going to bring in a lot of portal guys.
But portal they might bring opens today, right?
Yeah, I think so.
I believe
it's the portal this week. Yeah,
I believe the portal opens today on tax day. I believe that's when the portal day opens.
Hey, yeah, that's probably right. And it's a fair question. I wonder about it myself, but it's got to be the right guy. I would try. I mean, I would, because I don't feel comfortable if I were a coach with three scholarship guys. Unless one of my walk-ons was really good.
Yeah, unless you have somebody that's like, no, he's fine.
Right.
Because sometimes you might be like, well, okay, now we get to our fourth.
Right.
We're already probably in a pickle.
Right.
You know, so is the portal person going to be the one that saves it? If it's somebody that plays, it's somebody that's done that, that's a lot.
Yeah, but would that person be willing just to come in and play a subsidiary role, you know?
Yeah, you'd almost have to be promised the ability to compete. Be like, hey, listen, the job is still open. that's what you would want from a if you're a player. If it's like, does it be like the first thing be like, do I have a chance to compete?
No,
if
you're right.
If it's like, no, we want you to come in and just be in this role. They'll lay it out for you, and there's always a chance if something this and this happens. Unless it'd be like, no, I have a chance to compete.
It's a good point, and that's probably why. I don't know. There are some people who have said to me, why doesn't Rule just say, you know, can't he just kind of lay out what the situation is, and instead of being, you know, just saying, no, everybody's competing. I haven't even really looked for separation. Maybe part of the reason you do that is what Bill's saying is it'd make it harder to go into the portal to get somebody if he was on record saying, yeah, it's probably Dylan's job. Somebody's got to beat him. Or if he just named it. So, and then also, I think you just, if you're the head coach, you just carry it along and be indefinite about it because you worry about someone, maybe one of the other guys, like Heinrich leaving, you know?
Well, that's the way it is with the portal right now.
I know. That's what I'm saying. So maybe just keep
the
it.
Portal. The portal. This is in Wichita.
It's right down Wichita.
Thank God Wichita is pretty close. I mean, you can just motor down. You can drive down there.
Yeah. 4 hours away.
It's 4 hours. It's a nice little drive.
Drive down there and see if there's a quarterback with experience. Yeah. Have him throw out in that field. Yeah. It's roped off.
We've seen it. You've seen
the concession stand.
Right. Just go out, throw some, run a route tree.
Yeah. Someone will pick you up.
Run the two. Give me a four. Run the route tree. Let's do the whole tree.
Yeah, give me a
nine. Give me a nine. 8, 6, 5, 4. 9, 2.
Down in Wichita, run a route tree. Mm-hmm.
So you can't get out of this place.
So, yeah, that is a valid question.
Well, I think for me, what is the goal of the season? Nebraska's the main goal is, number one, get to a bowl game, right? It's been since 2016, and you have a schedule that's gettable. We've all said the schedule is extremely gettable for Nebraska to, at least in the first seven games, to potentially be bowl eligible by those last five games that get kind of tough.
Mm-hmm.
And is your best chance to go with a freshman quarterback who has a lot of potential, but also has never played at this high level before in a game?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it potentially getting a guy that has played at a different level as a starter in the transfer
portal? Yeah, we think a little bit different. I think they have their starter right now.
I'm not denying that that Dylan is the goal to be starter.
Right. I don't think they're – I mean, it's interesting. if your line of thinking is that they would still be open to finding a starter in the portal, that'd shock me. If they bring a guy in here, and I don't know, when would this be? In the next few weeks?
Well, you never get into like the, I use the word the pundits again and what they say, but that was the one thing, like I say in the article, that Mike Farrell said. Mike Farrell said that definitely Nebraska was going into the portal for a quarterback.
Did he say that?
That was one of his articles. I think I sent that to you, didn't I?
I believe
you
did.
A screenshot of it, yeah. Or something like that.
Is that off Facebook?
It's off of Facebook.com.
I don't know. I don't know and if that I did has that.
Nothing. I'm the first person to be like, what? What? Yeah. What does that have to do with anything that he's saying? I'm not sure it's factual.
Yeah.
It's just interesting to read.
It is interesting to think that that's a possibility. Now, I also understand what's going on.
Harley's yelling at us for some reason.
Harley yelled at us.
I also understand that you always want competition, and maybe you just bring in somebody that can threaten the whole room. It doesn't seem like the right move to me. It doesn't. Usually I'm that guy. Yeah, bring a guy in. Compete. Everybody compete. I don't know. The quarterback's a little different. It's a little different position than right guard.
I'm sure it's a different setup too on the who. You might look at it and go, oh, hang on now. Who's available? That's interesting. You don't know who that might be.
Yeah, I mean, just keep an open mind.
But the number three is very odd for a scholarship number.
It is. Very odd. Small.
Small.
Yeah. I would make me feel uncomfortable. Unless Jack Wokey. I mean, it might be Wokey. It's spelled W-O-C-H-E.
We get it.
Jack.
We say it different every time we talk, bring up his name.
Where's Jack from?
He's from South Lake, Texas. Yeah. Via Ole Miss. Yeah. And he might be all right. Luke Longvell might be okay. I mean, maybe one of those guys can play. That's I know you, like Sean will say, you're crazy. I don't know. You can find walk-ons that might be that can play a little bit. That's what I would try to do, or I would get those guys ready. Get them ready. You got you got three fields going over there. Get them ready.
Before we get to break, quick update from the Quiche restaurant here on the text line.
What do we have?
It's important to get this update here.
27th and O.
27th and O.
Casserole.
Texture says this.
Okay.
Looking at the online ordering for Quiche Restaurante Guatemalteco. Okay.
Guatemalteco.
I'm only seeing one thing on the menu with quiche in the name. It doesn't sound like a quiche. Must be a Guatemalan fare, as it looks more like a Mexican restaurant menu than a quiche restaurant.
There's a flag on there. You could look to see what that flag is. It's blue and white.
I might just go
with quiche the menu.
It says quiche restaurante. That's what it says.
Yes. With Guatemalteco at the end also.
Oh, so it must be a Guatemalan flag.
That's what they're saying.
Putting this together now.
I'm going to tell you right now, I would not ID the Guatemalan flag right. That's what that is. That's for sure.
Maybe not.
That would get me.
Blue and white.
Can blue someone white. Please?
I would not know that.
Can someone text either. In a picture of the Guatemalan
please
flag?
Please do, and yeah. I'll know it.
They will know. Steve will know if this is the Quiche restaurant representation.
Text line, please send us a Guatemalan flag.
Or also from YouTube.
Yeah.
YouTube, somebody. We need to see that the flag
please
looks
update
like.
Us.
We will do that. When we come back, a Masters final update on Early Break on the Ticket.
You're listening to Early Break with Steve Sippel, Jake Sorensen, and Bill Busch on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Looking for a job that feels like family? Join Lincoln Industries, where tradition meets innovation. They're a family-owned, privately held manufacturing company with a passion for excellence and a commitment to their community. They have openings on all shifts at both the main plant and airport facilities, offering flexibility to fit your schedule. Whether you're a seasoned professional or just starting out, there's a place for you there. At Lincoln Industries, they invest in their people's success, providing opportunities for growth and advancement. Apply now and become a part of something special at Lincoln Industries.
This is Coach Bill Busch. You all know my passion for Nebraska. Having coached all over the country, I can honestly say there is no place like Nebraska. You know where there's also no place like? Midwest Bank. Midwest Bank has proudly served Nebraska for over 70 years, and they're located in 9 different communities. Midwest Bank is ready, willing, and able to meet all your personal, business, and agriculture needs. Your community, your bank, and mine, Midwest Bank. Find out more at Midwest Bank. Member FDIC.
Buckle up and hang on. This is going to be a good one.
The fans of Kansas Speedway know how to have a good time. one that celebrates fantastic finishes and family-friendly facilities. Trading paint.
We got feuding.
And tailgating tradition. Burnouts, beer, and barbecue. Oh, it'll for sure be a good time, and you are all invited. NASCAR weekend at Kansas Speedway, May 4th and 5th. Get your tickets now at kansasspeedway.com.
Keep summer green with Judson Byline and Judson Irrigation. More than 40 years ago, Judson Irrigation started taking in orphans. Non-sprinkler systems installed by a quickie, cheapie summer job, install them and forget them outfit, long forgotten. Call Judson Irrigation. They'll never forget you.
Keep summer green. Call Judson Irrigation, 402-420-6277 or judsonirrigation.com.
If you're looking for a pre-owned tractor to upgrade your operation this year, you'll find a wide selection at your local Landmark Implement. We'll work with you to find the right equipment for your needs at a price that's right for you, all backed by Landmark's extensive parts and service network. During the month of April, get financing as low as 3.9% for up to 72 months on model year 21 through 23 wheeled 8R tractors. Visit LandmarkImp.com to see our complete inventory or stop by your local Landmark location today and experience the Landmark difference.
Ironhide Construction is hiring. They're looking for hardworking, self-motivated individuals who are team players. Ironhide Construction has openings for an experienced project manager, estimator, apprentice, skilled laborer, and erector or installer. They will train the right people and make sure you understand the position and requirements. At Ironhide Construction, it's own it, be honest, and do it right. Apply today and learn more about their other benefits at ironhideconstruction.com. Where they're committed to you every step of the way.
Hi, it's Joel Norman, the voice of your Lincoln Stars hockey team. Tune in to 93.7 The Ticket every Tuesday night from 8 to 9 p.m. to hear the latest on the Stars with myself, head coach Rocky Russo, and special player guests.
With the Planet Fitness Black Card, you don't just get a great workout, you get a great perk out, because your membership is packed with perks. For $1 down and $24.99 a month, you'll get perks like access to any of our 2,400 clean and spacious locations. Bring your friend anytime and both work out with tons of equipment that'll give you that big fitness energy. Relax in the Black Card Spa and more. Work out and perk out with the PF Black Card. Join for just $1 down and $24.99 a month.
Hurry, this deal ends soon.
See Home Club for details.
The Lincoln Marathon hits the streets Sunday, May 5th. Will you be part of the pack? Registration is now open for the full and half marathon at thelincolnmarathon.org. This event offers something for runners of all ages and abilities, from elite athletes to those looking to accomplish a fitness goal or check off a bucket list item. Sign up now to run the marathon on Sunday, May 5th. If running isn't in the cards, consider volunteering on race day. Complete event details can be found at lincolnmarathon.org.
Whether you're looking for a place to stay for a concert at PBA, a Nebraska home game, or just a night on the town, the Courtyard Lincoln Downtown Haymarket is the place for you. Enjoy an evening at one of many restaurants or bars within a short walking distance. Business travelers at the hotel will enjoy free high-speed internet access, a 24-hour business center, and large in-room workstations. And check out the Bistro, where you'll enjoy healthier food and beverage options, as well as high-tech conveniences. Book your room today at the Courtyard Lincoln Downtown Haymarket.
Do you need motivation to get to the gym on the weekend or even in general? Tune into the Movement Hour each Saturday from 10 to 11 a.m. Movement Academy owner Robert Kuhlman will host the show as he introduces new ways to stay in shape. The Movement Hour, every Saturday morning from 10 to 11 a.m. on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Hi, I'm Senator Bo Ballard. I was born and raised in Lancaster County, learning the value of hard work and grit at a young age. I built my own company, creating jobs right here in our community. I know that families and businesses in our community need lower taxes, lower costs of healthcare, and a great education. That's why as your senator, I helped pass the largest task and made the most significant investment in education in Nebraska history and worked to reduce the cost of healthcare. I'm Senator Bo Ballard, and I humbly ask for your vote on May 14th. Paid for by Ballard for Nebraska.
From here.
Back. Well, party's starting early today, isn't it?
To more of Early Break with Sip and Jay. Brought to you by Gaina Trucking. On 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com. We'll be right back.
on the Guatemalan flag here in a second. It's important to know that. Before that, though, the second segment is always sponsored by our friends at Bex Hybrids, the largest independent family-owned seed company. They want to wish farmers a safe and successful planting season. For any in-season seed needs, find your nearest Bex Hybrid seed rep at BexHybrids.com.
Good God.
It's a corn festival. I didn't get a chance. That's what's going on. I don't know if you guys were made. I don't know if you guys were made aware of this, but Trevor, who runs, he's the senior associate president of Bex, and he also went through with me, which I didn't know this. Do you guys know Sonny Beck, who runs the company? Was personally invited by Coach Painter for Purdue to come to the Final Four. He was personally invited. He was in Purdue gear right behind the bench.
No kidding.
How did we miss that?
Well, things got a little wacky, and so we didn't get a chance to talk about it. But yes, so Sonny Beck was right behind the bench.
Good God.
Right behind the bench. He is seed, and he's also a Boilermaker fan. He had the black with the P on it. Looked really good. He looked incredible.
He knows Painter.
He knows Painter personally.
So is Jake.
Yeah. Yeah, knows him personally.
But the painter doesn't laugh at Sonny Beck. He laughs at me.
Yes.
No laughing at Sonny.
That's interesting. So he was there.
So Corn Festival, and then also he was there for the finals. Corn
Festival.
They brought him in. Purdue brought him in. I'm sure he talked to the team. I'm not sure if he talked to right before the game started. Oh, yeah, I'm sure Sonny addressed the team. Mm-hmm. I know he spends a lot of time. A lot of people have said that Sonny Beck is the one that also has worked with Zach Edey's footwork on some things.
Well, he's done a good job. He's done a really nice job.
Same job he does with Seed, Jake.
Well, that's what he does. Yes. The three F's: faith, family, and farming. Bex Hybrids.
And footwork.
And big man footwork.
The four F's.
And four F's. BexHybrids.com. Got an update. So we asked for the people to text in to see what does the Guatemalan flag look like.
Yes.
It is indeed
the Guatemalan
flag you see at the Peace Restaurant at 27-0.
It's on the wall that faces 27th. That flag right there. Yeah.
That's the one.
It's blue and white.
I didn't know Guatemala was known for quiche. I didn't know that. Now we do.
Yeah. It's called Quiche Restaurante. Okay. That's what it's called. That's it. I just noticed it last night.
I promise I will stop in this place and look at the menu.
Okay.
I'll bring it up. I'll probably bring it
back. I don't need to see the menu. I'd be like, what would you like? I'll have the quiche. That's what I'm having.
There's other options.
But I'm not going to do that. If it's on the title, it's right up there.
You know what they specialize.
It's specialized like that, yes.
Thank you for the flag, whoever sent that. It's perfect.
We have about 20 of those texts, so thank you.
Thank you.
For
the breakers.
Yep, they're the best.
They're listening.
They're the best.
Jake said numbers were up when I was gone.
No, I didn't say that.
Jake said numbers were up.
That is not something I said.
Numbers were up when you were gone.
Bill is lying to the people once. He's lying to us. He's lying to us. I didn't say that. No, not true.
Numbers are up.
Why would you say that?
Yeah. Why would you say that?
It's a jerk. It's what I'm a jerk. That's why. Update from Augusta, Georgia. Another blowout in the Masters. Another rout. Scottie Scheffler wins the Masters by 4 strokes, 11 under par. He was 4 under par yesterday, a 68 for Scottie Scheffler, despite a kind of a tough start through 6-7 holes. He turned it on, his 3 straight birdies on 8-9-10, couple coming into the rest of the round, and he wins by 4 strokes over Ludvig Åberg in his first ever major appearance, oh, by the way, for Åberg.
I mentioned him Åberg.
I enjoyed watching him. He was always eating something. He had a sandwich on the deal. He had a protein bar. And he looked so happy. He was never a time just like I was stressed. No, I'm like, he's in his first
ever. He's a dude.
Right? He's a dude. I was impressed with him.
You mentioned the snack. On his way up from 9 to 10, there was video of him like getting high fives in the fans.
He fist bumped.
Somebody knocked the snack out of his hands.
Oh, yeah. Is that what happened? I don't think they went with this, though. It was
too firm of a fist pound, and he lost
it. But he had this protein bar in the same hand, he's fist bumping. So fans, don't take any heat on that one.
Okay.
But then he kind of looked at him and laughed.
He looked at him like, all right.
He paused. He
laughed.
I just lost my protein bar.
So Jake can answer this.
Yes, Sip.
Scheffler is regarded as perhaps, this is from ESPN's Schlabaugh, Mark Schlabaugh. Is Scheffler, the tall Texan, is regarded as perhaps golf's best ball striker since Tiger Woods in his prime.
I would agree with that.
Would you?
I would. McIlroy has been up and down. When McIlroy's on, he is an incredible ball striker, but he's been so inconsistent the last couple of years, he can't say that right now. Same for Dustin Johnson, same for Brooks Koepka. Scottie Scheffler doesn't have bad rounds. A bad round for Scottie is even par.
He's been number one. Bill would be interested in this. Think about this. He's been number one in the world for 80 weeks. For 80 weeks.
It's pretty solid.
Number one golfer. Wouldn't it be weird to be the number one golfer in the world? Think about that. There's not that many.
Like, I think it's more weird when they talk about that he's the incredible ball striker. Just plays golf. He's a ball striker.
He's the best ball striker. Well, he strikes the ball.
To be fair, everybody strikes the ball well.
Yeah, they're all pros. They all strike the ball well. I mean, so that, what that
they
it's,
said.
It's, I know
they say that because
it's
he's,
a it's a little phrase they've made up to sound cool. Yeah, that's right. All it is. It's a phrase they made. He's a ball striker.
Is it the same thing Ludwig Edberg said? Ludwig
Åberg. And it looks like Åberg, but it's looks Åberg. Like Åberg. I know it's Åberg though. For some reason,
he said obviously Scottie is an unbelievable golf player.
Thank you. That's better than ball striker.
Cool.
So you can see, he's a,
Well, 80 weeks. I mean, that would be, I think it's 80 weeks.
To defend those trying to describe him as a ball striker, he hits at the ball a mile. He's up there with the longest hitters in tour. He's always down the middle. He's always in the fairway. Yeah. Missed only like two fairways yesterday. He's always down the middle.
Great irons player, too. Yeah.
Wedge player. His putting is his downfall, and he made putts yesterday. Missed a couple short ones early on, but again, he had seven birdies yesterday. Seven.
Good God,
The lead, the guy who won, he had the second lowest round of the entire day of anybody in the field. He pulled away. Second master title in 3 years. He didn't win last. John Rahm won last year, but Scotty won in 2022.
He's only won a. He's only won one major.
It's the second major.
But Masters is the only major he's won. He's never won another major.
If you look at his last 3 years, he's finished in the top 10, I think, 8 times out of 10 majors.
He's won two majors, both Masters.
Top 10, 8 times.
That's ball striking.
Well, look at his last 35 months. He's won 3 tournaments. Yeah. In the last month, he's won three tournaments. He's on a heater, in other words, as Bill would say.
Two golfers can say ever they've won the Players' Championship and the Masters the same year. That is Tiger Woods and Scottie Scheffler.
Yeah, he won that and the Arnold Palmer Invitational.
Look at you.
Yes.
Golf guru over here, Steve Sipple.
Scheffler's.
Does everyone have to drink Arnold Palmer's?
Yes.
When they're at the event?
Yes. Before and after.
Yes, before and after. I'll have an Arnold Palmer, please.
Yeah, you will have one because that's
all we have.
Right.
Want water? Nope.
We got an Arnold Palmer over here.
Scheffler.
I like the name too. Scheffler.
He's somebody. It's hard.
I like the name.
It's hard to root against him.
Yeah.
It's hard to root against him.
Yeah, he's a good dude.
He's a lovable dude. He's a happy-go-lucky guy.
Very emotional though, up and down.
He's the most stable guy ever out there. Yeah, there's a guy out there, Tyrrell Hatton, who is playing in this round. I want to punch that guy in the face sometimes.
Whoa, okay, all right. Tell us why.
If anybody watching golf, his name is Tyrrell Hatton, T-Y-R-E-L-L.
Who's this guy?
He's from England. He's on Live now, Live Golf Tour. But this is the guy that every time he misses a putt, he said, oh, my God, there's no possible way. There's no way I misread that. Oh, my God.
See the guy in the beard?
Yes.
Okay,
that's the one.
Yeah, he looked back at his caddy just like,
yes,
he looked at his caddy like, you're an idiot.
See?
I hit it right where you told me to hit it.
That's the guy I'm talking about. He's like, just shut up, Tyrrell. Yeah.
He has a punchable face.
I said, you're 9 strokes out of the first place. Shut the hell up, man. Shut up, Tyrrell.
This took an interesting turn.
I know. By the way, Tiger Woods finished dead last in the tournament. Of those who made the cut.
Made the cut, so not dead last.
So he was plus one going into the weekend. Made a cut by 6 strokes, and plus 7 was the cut line. He was plus one. Very good first two rounds.
He's talking he had a chance. He's only like 7 strokes back. He's like, I got a chance.
He shot an 82, which is 10 over par on Saturday.
That's what you'd shoot.
I would shoot worse than that at the Masters.
Would you?
Yeah, I'm not.
You can't shoot 82.
No, I don't think so. That's an incredibly tough course. And he shoots a 77 yesterday. So he finishes, of those who made the cut, dead last. But again, he beat out Dustin Johnson, who missed the cut. Jordan Spieth missed the cut.
Dustin Johnson, did he have the problem with the 3-putt? And then he cursed at the spectators and he said he didn't.
That was Zach Johnson.
Zach!
Did you see that video?
No, I didn't see that.
Zach Johnson, two-time major winner. Zach Johnson, who, of course, is from Iowa, Cedar Rapids, Iowa, where he's from.
Short guy.
He's on hole 12, the par 3, okay?
Bad.
He has the worst tee shot I've ever seen on that hole. He pulls it 40 yards left into the woods. He's got a drop for a third shot off the tee. He hits over the green. He three putts for a six. He's triple bogey. And he hears like a mocking cheer from the fan base, which is back by the tee box. And he basically says, oh, F off, basically.
Yeah, he said F off. Very audible.
Very audible. It's audible. It's you can't deny it.
It's sort of stunning. Like, you're like, ooh, did he just said that.
That's it's very, yeah, there's no way you could not push back. It was 100% oh, F off to the fans who gave him the sarcastic cheer for his six on that hole.
And then afterward, he was asked about it, and somebody suggested you said an expletive, and he said, that's laughable. He goes, no. He goes, no. I didn't do that. That's laughable.
No, you said
it's right there. It's like, don't say that.
There's microphones everywhere. In Augusta National. So you said
no. I'll tell you one thing. It'll be addressed because that is what the beauty of that competition is, the history and the class. And the tradition. And there, you don't get a. After a while, it's like, I'm going to do it this way. No, you're not. No, we don't like your shirt, Mr. Day.
Yeah,
change your
Jason
shirt.
Jason did take off that sweater.
We don't like it. Change
Mr. Day.
It. Yeah. Well, yeah. Just very nicely, Mr. Day. Yeah,
Mr. Day.
Remove your sweater and put something else on.
I told you
everything they do.
Yeah, Jake nailed that one. He did. He said
Friday morning. He said, "What is Jason Day wearing?" And he had to take it off for the back nine.
But they just—it's like, no, we're going to wear the caddies wear this. I don't want to wear that.
No,
it's okay. You don't have to. No. He just won't be here.
Yeah,
he won't be here.
Okay. You don't have to be here if you don't want.
So there it is.
If you watch the power walking when they open the gates. Oh, have you seen that?
Can't run.
So you can't run.
Can't run.
So they open the gates and they show it, and everyone can power walk. You see people just power. It's incredible.
You can't run.
You can't run. There's no running, and there's people standing there yelling at them like, "Don't run, don't run."
I wonder what that's interesting.
Yeah, that's interesting. No running at the Masters.
Power walk.
And by the way, no cell phones either. No cell phones.
Whoa.
And which is awesome. Beauty.
It's beautiful.
And you know, someone probably tries to sneak in. I'd love somebody going at you. Yeah, you're gone.
Yep.
You're out. Get out.
No second chance.
No second chance. You're out.
You knew the rule. You're
no
out of
cell
here.
Phone.
No cell phones.
So congrats to Scottie Scheffler, 2-time Masters champion. Wins by 4 strokes. PGA Championship is in May. That's the next major on the PGA Tour.
Nice.
Okay. When we come back, Song of the Day and Bill's Thrills early break on the ticket. Yeah.
You're listening to Early Break with Steve Sippel, Jake Sorensen, and Bill Busch on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Not many businesses can say they've made it 60 years, but Madsen's Bowling and Billiards can. With 12 bowling lanes and the biggest pool room in Nebraska, where else would you go to enjoy an afternoon or evening? There's a great daily specials like $2 Tuesdays, games of bowling, shoe rentals, draft beers, and tacos, all just $2 each. Have a delicious burger at EJ's Lounge before or after your bowling or pool session, and you'll leave satisfied. Madsen's Bowling and Billiards at 47th and Dudley.
Community means something different to everyone. But for me, it means cheering on those around you during the good times and helping them out during the tough times. I'm softball player Jordy Ball, and I've been blessed with the support of my friends, family, coaches, and community throughout my life. When looking for a bank to call home, it was easy to choose Midwest Bank. I never feel like just another customer, and they're proud to support their communities. They love what they do, and it shows. Your community, your bank, Midwest Bank.
Hi, this is State Senator Carolyn Bozen. Education is a cornerstone to building a strong, vibrant community. I voted for the historic increase in funding for education in the legislature. As a state senator, wife, and mom, I believe Lincoln is a great place to work and raise a family. My husband Reggie and I are local business owners and understand the valuable role of education in our community. This is Carolyn Bozen, and I am asking for your vote on May 14th, paid for by Bozen for Legislature.
If you're in Seward or Milford, listen up. Select Plumbing is now servicing your area with no trip charges from Lincoln. Select Plumbing works on a variety of issues for your home and business, including general plumbing, water heaters, faucet and fixture repair, underground sewer and water repairs, backflow testing, and more. Keep your property free from leaks and other issues. Call today for a free estimate, 402-560-6197. It's not just Lincoln, Waverly, and the surrounding area anymore. It's also Seward and Milford with no trip charges. Contact Select Plumbing to inquire at 402-560-6197.
Buckle up and hang on. This is going to be a good one.
The fans of Kansas Speedway know how to have a good time. One that celebrates fantastic finishes. Family-friendly facilities. trading paint.
We've got feuding
and tailgating tradition. Burnouts, beer, and barbecue. Oh, it'll for sure be a good time, and you are all invited. NASCAR weekend at Kansas Speedway, May 4th and 5th. Get your tickets now at kansasspeedway.com.
With the Planet Fitness Black Card, you don't just get a great workout, you get a great perk out, because your membership is packed with perks. For $1 down and $24.99 a month, you'll get perks like access to any of our 2,400 clean and spacious locations. Bring your friend anytime and both work out with tons of equipment that'll give you that big fitness energy. Relax in the Black Card Spa and more. Work out and perk out with the PF Black Card. Join for just $1 down and $24.99 a month.
Hurry, this deal ends soon.
See Home Club for details.
Jake Sorensen here for The Body Shop. My wife is nearing her due date with our first child and has been in need of a good massage as her body continues to change and adapt. Dennis and the team at The Body Shop were incredible with the prenatal massage that she's still talking about today. I was also able to get a deep tissue massage, so it was a great bonding experience and a unique couples massage in general. If you're in need of stress relief, book a massage today at thebodyshoplincoln.com. The Body Shop at 48th and A.
Your home is your empire. Protect it with Empire Fence. Get a free instant quote with the online estimating tool at empire-fence.com. See an upfront estimate with no hidden fees. An Empire Fence can provide privacy and improve the appearance of your home. Keep kids and pets in or out of your yard. Increase security and add value to your property. Visit empire-fence.com now to view the stylish and maintenance-free possibilities for your home and get a free instant online quote. Let Empire Fence protect your empire.
You love to bash his sports takes.
Now, will you feel like an idiot if you're you're a big tough guy this morning?
But you really love to voice your displeasure for his music choices.
He stumbled on an issue that I did not think would generate this much passion and discussion.
It's time for Jake's questionable song of the day on Early Break on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Once again, your song of the day, The Waiting by Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, 464-568-51 is bad. 10 is good. Texture rating on the Sauter Heyman Jewelers song of the day.
Well, you're in the nines for sure. What year was that?
81.
Yeah, I mean, it's some of it, I wonder sometimes if I like Petty, Bill, Jake, because it takes me back to a better time. it's an incredible time times. In my life.
Yeah, yeah. It was.
Bill, me and Bill, it was the best. I peaked out in about 81, actually. Yeah. God, that's a long time from my peak. Stop.
33 years.
Stop.
Right? No, more than that.
Yeah, it's more than that. Anyway, yeah, that's one of Tom's better songs. I mean, it's probably top 10. So it's automatically, if it's a top 10 Petty song, it's automatically a 9. 9.27768.
Nice. I like Petty. I'm not nowhere.
Never heard that.
I'm before. Never near anywhere close to what you guys, the Xanadu that hits you guys. Yeah. That's not even.
You said the right word.
And Xanadu. I like it. And I like Petty. There's some things about him that is very enjoyable to me. It's moderately might change the song. It's a 6-2.
It's fine.
Best. Yeah,
it's fine. 6-2.
I mean, it's.
You don't share.
I'm not sure it's even top 10 Petty. And well, it's not would change. Petty. It's not a walk up song. It's not. It doesn't bring.
It's okay.
Anything, any sort of.
We just have a different outlook on Petty.
Petty, and I like Petty. I'm not anti.
There's Xanadu for me.
But this song would not do anything. But it does bring me back to better times. I knew all the words, so it's like I've heard it a bunch.
Xanadu. Is it top five for you, Petty? It's top five for me for Petty.
I don't know if I could squeeze it into the top five.
I mean, he's got like 20 songs to choose from, 30 to choose from.
Yeah, no, not top five. Okay. But I think I can get it in the top 10.
We got to guess Josh's score over here. I assume Josh probably likes
Josh's it. Is almost, I would say Josh is out of control, but Farley is way out of control today.
We've lost Farley.
Terrell Farley.
I don't know.
What's going on?
He yelled at us.
He yelled at us.
He asked Josh an inappropriate question. I mean, completely inappropriate. HR wouldn't even know what to do with that question.
He'd be fired on the spot, actually.
He would be fired on the spot.
We're going to know now because HR is going to be here now that you announced on the radio.
At any rate.
7-2.
I'm going 8 for Josh. Right. 8 flat.
Okay. I like – Bill is uncanny with how good he predicts these scores. I'll say 7.
9.1.
Whoa.
9-1. Tom Pitt. He's a Tom Pitt.
Look how excited Jake is. Look at his nose. Tail's wagging.
Yeah, it's wagging over there.
It's like sugar.
I don't know that he is a Tom Petty fan.
He doesn't like the Eagles. Right. He doesn't like the Eagles. He likes Tom Petty.
I'm glad Farley asked the question now.
Okay. Some ratings here. Some ratings here. Notorious.
Yours inappropriate is Farley.
BIB 8.5. Rod in South Lincoln says, good way to start the week. That's a 9. Triple H's dad, a 5. Brad from the Baldwin Shop says, solid 7. Welcome back, Bill, by the way.
God bless you. From the Baldwin Shop. The Baldwin Shop welcomed you. If you had a welcome back from the Baldwin Shop.
That means a lot to me.
Yeah. It means a lot.
That means a lot, especially since I've been to the Baldwin Shop.
Yes.
You've been there.
Oh, that was so much fun going over there.
Yeah.
Just seeing the faces of everybody that is holding this city together.
They are.
Yeah, that was incredible. Sean, anything from Vince from Napa?
I haven't seen Vince today in Napa. Sean and Omaha gives it a 9. Who in Columbus? 7.4.
Ooh.
Pretty solid. By
he went with the decibel.
Yeah. He did. That is uncommon, right? Good call. He's just a flat number.
Yeah. Wow.
Ryan in California, 8.4. Believer says, pure crap. Negative 9.
Pure crap.
Negative 9.
That's strong.
Come on, Believer. Corey Lincoln, a 7. Oscar Mike in Waterloo, a 7.5. Isaac says, 8.5. Dino, 7.2. The Texas Casanova says, I've never heard that song before. He's 39 years old.
How old?
39.
That's the funniest thing I've ever
heard.
That's
impossible.
That's the best response to anything so far. I've never heard that song before.
That's impossible with the way. It's impossible. What do you listen to, Casanova? Jennifer 7.
What about Beef Taco?
7.9. I don't see Beef Taco.
Wait a second.
Here.
Jennifer what?
7 and Hubby 7.9.
Good score.
They said, great start to the week on that one.
It was.
It was a good start. I gave it a 6.
It's not bad.
6-2. Yeah.
Before Bill throws a quick legal idea, hang on 1 second here.
This is Lincoln's home for sports talk on the FM dial. Also online at theticketfm.com.
On the internet.
KNTK FM Firth, 93.7 The Ticket.
Let's get to Bill's Thrills on a Monday. Here we go.
Some call him the most interesting man in the world.
That is setting up the morel mushroom.
Yes.
Bonanza.
Oh, yeah.
This is going to be bonanza.
Mushrooms grow better with thunder and lightning.
Others call him Coach. But to everyone else, he's Bill.
I want to get one of those military ab stimulators for us to wear during the show. You see, I sent you today.
It's time for Bill's Thrills on Early Break, sponsored by Dirk, Scott, and Ty at Mid Plains Advisors.
Yes, as always, Bill's Thrills sponsored by Dirk, Scott, and Ty at Mid Plains Advisors, the ATMs, the cash cows of Lincoln. Call them at 402-730-7387. We missed Bill last week. Me and Sipcha did the best we could to fill in.
We muddled.
We tried. It wasn't the same. So
there'd be no muddling. You guys are above muddling. You're way ahead of that.
It was fine.
We tried. Right. We did our best we could. We did our best we could. But Bill is back to take his throne for Bill's Thrills.
Right. I was so back to be
You're
back.
You're taking your throne.
On back. Bill's it's Thrills. So back to be back with the cash cows also.
We should
also, just so everyone knows right now, they had Scheffler. They had Scheffler as the winner. Did. So if you'd have taken their advice and wagered with them and then ran it through the tax-free app, right now you'd be on your way to Fiji.
Damn it.
Yeah. Whoa. All expenses paid.
How's that sound?
That's Fiji. What would have happened. Good. Just listen to these guys.
Fiji's an interesting place.
Fiji. They know everything they're doing. I'm telling you what. These guys, they're pure brilliance is what they are. Fiji. They're ahead of the game financially.
Fiji.
Yes. So we talked about it. So Monday is football. So I went football fantasy. Mm. Football fantasies that don't happen. Sip's getting a phone call.
He is getting a phone
Sip
call.
Sip got a phone call. Who would be calling you during the show?
Yeah, I don't know.
Who would be calling you during the show? They called during the show. That's incredible. Anyway, so football fantasy for me was things that don't happen. That it just doesn't happen in this world at all. Occasionally, you'll get a reunion. Even that's not that much. So football fantasy for me was I got invited by the University of Utah head coach Kyle Whittingham invited me out for 3 days to observe practice to meet with their staff on certain things. So it's professional development for both sides for me.
Professional development.
For me and from the other side. But the cool thing about it is when I get out there is that, so Kyle Whittingham and myself are the two coaches that were retained by Urban Meyer when Urban came in, and they kept two of us. That was the two that stayed. And then Kyle stayed on, and everyone, you heard Urban say it the other day. I mean, everyone would agree right now that man for man, he's probably the best coach in college football, getting the most out of his talent, what he's done. Somebody like, oh, they've had a little more success, or they've done this, especially now with someone of like a Nick Saban retiring, or mm-hmm. they don't have the same
Kirby.
They don't have they don't have all the same same power behind them as far as financial, but they're really good. Their facility, okay, their facility is unreal. It is unreal. You're standing on the field. And you're on the two fields or practice fields on both sides are it's 75 degrees out and both sides are mountains capped with snow. It when you see it's incredible.
That'd be pretty nice.
But here's what doesn't happen. You don't get together with past people. So obviously Kyle and myself worked together. He was a D coordinator. I was his DB coach at the time. Then we've stayed great friends ever since and always keep in touch. Then I go over the offensive coordinator. My best friend, Andy Ludwig.
Andy Ludwig.
A complete guru of football. They have two Pac-12 championships with him at the helm.
Two Pac-12
and so we were together at Wisconsin. So one of my best friends in the history of coaching. Then I go over to defense. Like, well, about the defensive coordinator? Well, it's Morgan Scally. He played for me. We had the whole conversation. He was a running back. I made him come over to defense. I made him suggested it, came over. I go, Morgan, you'll be an all-conference player. He really was an all-conference. He ended up being the defensive player of the year.
What position?
Safety.
It was a safety.
So he moved him over there. So the two coordinators, I know with that. I know the whole staff. So to get a chance to have a reunion like that with an entire staff, I'm talking to Lewis Powell, the D-line coach. He pulled the miracle out in the north end zone. We're playing BYU. We're going to end the game. We're probably going to lose. It's like first and one at the one. All of a sudden, there's a quarterback sneak and kind of a scrum, and no one really knows what's going on. All of a sudden, Lewis Powell just comes out of it with the ball, has the ball, no review. The officials kind of looked at themselves like, what do you think? I don't know. Gave the ball to us at Utah.
Utah.
Yeah, so it was incredible.
Louis Powell.
So he's coaching the D-line. Luther Ellis, who played, I think, 10 to 12 years in the NFL. He's their other D-line coach. So get a chance. And I know him well. Get a chance to spend time. But you don't get a chance. These reunions, guys have reunions. This is like my own reunion with all these people. They don't exist.
No.
You never get back to get with these people. There's none. I've never gotten together with my group from Utah State. Never gotten together with my group from LSU.
Too fast.
Their life goes too fast. There's too many directions. Yeah. And then all of a sudden you want to have a reunion down the road like 20, 30 years and okay, it happens. And then you see some people at that time. But in general, it doesn't happen.
Nope.
So I'm just a big proponent of that. And then I send a text message out as I'm there to Alex Smith. Alex Smith was first round pick from Utah that I was lucky enough to have a chance to recruit. And I go
first rounder.
No, Alex, number one overall. I sent a text to him, so he texts back right away. How's the number 11 looking? They have a new quarterback, freshman quarterback. So he's
on it.
Texts back right away. We talked about Utah and stuff. I sent a bunch of pictures of because Alex donated everything for the new weight room.
Really?
Oh, wow. So I texted all the pictures, all the different stuff.
He donated it.
So to be able to go back and forth and be able to talk to him about different things, we just had all these old stories of all these good times, and it was just incredible to be able to get back together with a group And then it also was a lot of fun for me just to get back into football.
So they're practicing.
Oh, yeah. Matter of fact, spring game is Saturday.
How do they look?
They look rare. They're a very good team.
Do they look like a team that, the Pac-12 is no longer. Where are they?
It'll be interesting. Big 12. So we had the conversation when I was there of the things that are going to be hard. When you go into a new conference,
they're going in the Big 12.
Every game is different now. They're used to playing USC,
right.
UCLA, Arizona State. They're used to playing all these teams. Mm-hmm. Now it's a whole new deal. Mm-hmm. But as Coach Whittingham pointed out, it's a whole new deal for them also. All the other teams, now that's a new deal for them. Now there's several teams came with them.
Mm-hmm.
Also, what stands out about Utah is, in my opinion, there's three. There's the Michigan, Ohio State, Auburn, Alabama. And I think the next best one, if not right there, is BYU, Utah.
Because
rivalries. And people say USC, UCLA. They'll say it's a rivalry. Then you just turn it on. Their stadium's half full. Utah, BYU, it is the most hatred. And here's the reason to have it. You have to have a rivalry. But to have a rivalry, both teams have to turn the keys, which means you're our rival. Some people say we have a rivalry. I mean, Nebraska says it about Iowa. That's our rival. Iowa's go. They push back. They're like, no, we're not. No, that's not our main rivalry.
What did they do?
Shake their head. That's not it. So when you don't have a rival, can you just say right now? I mean, if you go back, just take out the last what? When did Nebraska win the Big Ten? 12 years ago, something like that.
Won the Big Ten?
Yeah. When did Nebraska come into the Big Ten?
When did they come in? Yeah. I thought you said, when did they win the Big Ten? I was like, I don't.
What year?
11.
I missed right? that.
2011.
When they won the Big Ten.
So then prior to that, them and Iowa played like 5-6 times. They don't play. Right. They didn't play each other. Right. So you don't have a natural rival. They have one that's they've been playing for every year for 100 years.
They push back on that. Yeah.
Yeah, they push back on it. They do push back on it. But anyway, my point is just when you have a rival, and now Utah and BYU are back in the same league again.
Ooh.
They're back. So now they're playing. They're in the same league. So
it is hatred. Too.
So it is fun. They're, if talk about fun, playing in a game, that game's fun.
It's intense.
It's fun. But anyway, just a chance to get back to that. And my point of this whole Bill's Thrills is get your reunion on. Go meet people that mean a lot to you. That's what was the most
get
important.
Get your reunion on.
I like that phrase.
Get your reunion on.
You can say on at the end of a lot of things.
Yeah.
Get your dance on. Get your drink on. Yeah. Get your lunch on. Yeah. Get your dinner on.
We're going to go with get your reunion on.
Get your reunion on
today.
Get your reunion
on. If you don't get those chances to go see those people and have a chance, wherever it is, right now, who do you still know at the Journal Star?
A lot of people.
Go see them.
Get them on. I thought about that yesterday.
Get your reunion on. Walking around like that would be great.
Or just go into the Journal Star.
You go into the Journal Star and walk around like that. Start talking.
Who's this guy? Who's the old guy?
Who's the old guy? Yeah.
Who's the old guy?
But it was
get your reunion on.
It matters like that. And then also it's very healthy. It's healthy for me to see good people, talk some ball, hang out in meetings.
And you were out in the beautiful environment.
Yeah, it was beautiful like that. I got 3 days out there. That was a lot of fun.
Seemed recharged.
And I got to meet spirit animals on the trip.
At Starbucks,
and then at where I broke the pepper in Minneapolis on the flight home.
You met your spirit animal at a Starbucks in
Utah. That was in Salt Lake City. Incredible airport.
Is it?
Yeah, it's all been redone.
Strangely, never been there.
It's a very nice airport.
I don't remember.
There's two Delta hubs that will blow your mind, and it's Atlanta and Salt Lake City. Salt Lake City is the hub to the entire Western universe. It's like everyone flies through Salt Lake City.
Salt Lake City, it's a great airport.
I believe you.
They have an NBA team.
And now an NHL team, the Coyotes, are moving to Salt Lake City.
I guess I've always flown through Denver, it seems like.
Try Salt Lake City next time.
Okay.
That is Bill's Thrill, sponsored by Dirk, Scott, and Ty at Mid Plains Advisors. Hour two next, an early break in the ticket.
You're listening to Early Break with Steve Sippel, Jake Sorensen, and Bill Busch on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Liberty Law Group is committed to the defense of your liberty and pursuit of your justice for those that have been injured. My name is Seth Morris, attorney with Liberty Law Group. If you've been injured in an accident that wasn't your fault, call 877-42-LIBERTY. Our relentless trial attorneys are committed to the highest quality legal representation. At Liberty Law Group, we will fight for you. Call 877-42-LIBERTY. Again, That's 877-42-LIBERTY.
The Lincoln Marathon hits the streets Sunday, May 5th. Will you be part of the pack? Registration is now open for the full and half marathon at thelincolnmarathon.org. This event offers something for runners of all ages and abilities, from elite athletes to those looking to accomplish a fitness goal or check off a bucket list item. Sign up now to run the marathon on Sunday, May 5th. If running isn't in the cards, consider volunteering on race day. Complete event details can be found at lincolnmarathon.org.
Gaina Trucking is hiring CDL Class A and B drivers. Gaina Trucking guarantees a 40-hour work week year-round, and their strong team culture makes it not a job, but a career. Gaina Trucking offers health, vision, and dental insurance, 401k with company match, an employee assistance program, and other bonus programs. Build a better career today with great team culture at Gaina Trucking. Learn more and apply today at GainaTrucking.com.
One action, no matter how small, can have a world of impact on the life of a child. Cedars started because one couple believed that they could provide a child with a better life. And that belief grew into the Cedars that we know today. A powerful force for good that helps thousands of kids across Nebraska. Belief grows.
Hi, I'm Senator Bo Ballard. I was born and raised in Lancaster County, learning the value of hard work and grit at a young age. I built my own company, creating jobs right here in our community. I know that families and businesses in our community need lower taxes, lower costs of healthcare, and a great education. That's why as your senator, I helped pass the largest tax cut and made the most significant investment in education in Nebraska history and worked to reduce the cost of healthcare. I'm Senator Bo Ballard, and I humbly ask for your vote on May 14th. Paid for by Ballard for Nebraska.
It's getting nicer outside, but it's still hit or miss in the spring on golf weather. Not at Double Eagle Golf, your home for always 72 degree weather and no wind. Book a bay with some friends for a weekend or come by for golf and happy hour on a weekday. Spring leagues are underway, but stay tuned for info on indoor golf tournaments and book your bay for the Masters in April. That's all at Double Eagle Golf inside the Kinetic Sports Complex on West O Street. Online at doubleeagle.golf.
Hi, it's Joel Norman, the voice of your Lincoln Stars hockey team. Tune in to 93.7 The Ticket every Tuesday night from 8 to 9 p.m. to hear the latest on the Stars with myself, head coach Rocky Russo, and special player guests.
Are you looking to get into the electrical construction industry or wanting a new scene? The Electrical Workers of Local Union 265 are now hiring licensed journeymen and apprentices and are offering great pay and benefits. Call Mike at 402-875-1034 to apply. Start your electrical career today.
Empower a child today with the Teammates Mentoring Program. Hope is only a conversation away when you choose to share your talent, time, and heart with a child. Together, you can build a relationship based on strengths and chart a brighter future one week at a time. Find out how you can be a mentor by visiting LincolnTeammates.org. Become what you needed as a kid by joining the Teammates Mentoring Program today.
Sandhills Global is hiring. With their fast-paced, growing culture, they have hundreds of new openings in sales, marketing, traveling support, software development, web design, and more. Full-time roles offer a 4.5-day work week, along with flexible internships in most areas. Career and internship opportunities are available at our global headquarters in Lincoln, Nebraska. Find your fit today at www.sandhills.jobs.
You're spending $300 a month. Binge drinking is the most common form of excessive drinking, which costs the United States more than $191 billion each year. By drinking less, you will save $300 a month. If you or a loved one is looking for help, find a treatment facility near you at findtreatment.gov. For immediate support, call, text, or chat 988.
Brought to you by Nebraska DHHS in partnership with SAMHSA.
Wake up, Lincoln.
I overslept. Damn rooster didn't crow.
It's time for Early Break. Sponsored by Midwest Bank. Live from Lincoln, America.
Here's 93.7 The Ticket's Jake Sorensen.
I'm wrong, but I'm not.
Husker Online, Steve Sipple.
If I were a feral cat.
And longtime college football assistant coach. Bill Busch.
You can get one team. Mine's the Houston Oilers. I'm not the Texans, and I'm not the Titans, so I'm out.
This is Early Break.
Monday. Steve Sipple, Jake Sorensen, Bill Busch on Early Break. Hour two, sponsored by our friends at Midwest Bank. Member
FDIC.
Location in South Lincoln and 27th in Jamie Lane. Now also at 70th and Pioneers in the wonderful stone building at the southeast corner.
Yellowstone.
I saw this weekend a lot of landscaping going in at Midwest Bank. It's looking pretty out there.
It looks really pretty out there.
Pretty.
And you whiz right back behind
handsome?
Right there.
Just say handsome.
Pretty. And you got Popeye's chicken right there too.
That's a pretty good place.
Okay, I need to envision this. Yeah. Say the place again.
Midwest Bank.
I know, but what's the address?
70th and Pioneers.
What he just said earlier.
70th and Pioneers. Earlier.
Yeah.
The southeast corner.
I'm trying to envision it. What's all there?
Well, Bill just said there's a Popeye's over there.
What else?
Seconds ago.
Hy-Vee.
There's the Poor Craft and Spirits place. There's like a State Farm over there also. Hy-Vee. Scooters.
Okay. I think I'm starting to
come to me. Yeah. You've been over there before.
It's starting to come to me a little bit.
There's a lot going on in that intersection. There's a lot.
It's a busy place.
Well,
last week we didn't know what Steve Schindler was doing because you were gone. You couldn't give us the update, Bill. Yeah. He
had to have a little time to refresh a little bit too.
I would think Steve's got a lot going on.
We've got till today's big, though. I'm telling you.
What do we got going on today?
It's Magic Monday. Steve will be in a cape and a hat.
In a cape.
Doing magic tricks for those who come in. Old school. You got your classic card tricks.
He can do magic.
And he's going to have Tamara there. He's going to make a lady disappear.
Whoa.
He's going to cut her in half. It's old school. Cut her in half.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. Doing all the stuff. Bugs is there because he's going to pull a rabbit out of a hat.
He's doing the whole thing.
He's doing all the classics. Remember the old one like that where you pour the milk into like a cone of paper? And like, how can that happen? They can do it. Steve can do all those tricks. And so he will be there performing as people come in. But the big one was when he makes Tamara disappear.
He makes his wife disappear.
At 1:44, poof, gone.
A lot of dudes would like to know that trick.
Yeah.
It's
a popular act.
He is amazing.
Yeah. So he's in a cape and a hat. He's got a cape and a hat on all day. Yeah, top hat. He has a top hat. He can touch on things like that.
And how many shows?
What's that? Three separate shows. Three separate shows. One over the noon hour, one at 9:44, a little bit later than 8:44, then a 1:44.
Wait a second. Yes. Do it again.
9:44, 12:02, and 11 and 1:44.
Okay.
Yeah, so he has three shows he'll be doing
with
his magic. It's Magic Monday. He has some great card tricks too.
Will he show people how to do it?
No, how'd you do that? No, that's not how it works.
I just was wondering.
Yeah, no. That's not how it works.
Can't ruin that.
So he's got Magic Monday set up. He's in a cape. If you look,
of course
for him,
he can do magic tricks. What can he do? I'm not a jealous person, but people who can do magic tricks, I'm jealous.
I am too. Card tricks always get me too.
Think about him in the cape and the hat right now.
I've been thinking about it the whole time that Bill's been talking. Yeah.
How good will he look in a cape?
Really good.
Perfect
really
good. In a cape. I mean, if there's one person who should be in a cape, you say Steve Shin Schindler. Daddy.
He'll do all the stuff too. And there'll be music going.
Music playing. Oh, absolutely.
Tam will have to do a little presentation.
She will.
God.
He'll be in an outfit.
That'll be incredible fun. This might be the best one of all. To be honest.
Magic Man.
Will they dim the lights?
They'll dim the lights.
God.
Downtown Scott says, I've always said he's a magic man.
He is the magic man.
Steve Schindler.
We should get a t-shirt made with Schindler on it and just call it the magic man. The magic man.
Is this something he just took up or just something he's been doing for?
Doing it all his life.
Yeah, of course.
Been doing it all his life. Yeah.
But
it's all old school tricks. The old school stuff.
I mean, we always think of Larry the Cable Guy as a big local celebrity. I don't know.
Right there.
Shindy's pushing him for that spot.
Yeah.
Top celebrity.
Kind of low key, though.
I wonder if we can get Shindy on with Larry the Cable Guy.
Well, I mean, I wonder.
Radio Gold.
Yeah. I don't know. Does Larry Cable Guy get whisked around?
Does he get whisked in a motorcade?
No. I'm going to say no.
He gets sent down here to get the AD thing fixed.
They whisked him, and he fixed it, by the way.
He did it.
He got down here. He met with LeBlanc first just to see how everything looked. That meeting he told me with Dennis was more educational to him.
Oh, right.
Because Dennis Yeah, because Dennis was just like, I got, you know, it was, but Dennis wasn't like an arrogant. He just, Steve listened to him and he just walked out and he goes, well, I'm glad I got whisked down here to go meet with the Regents, but we don't have to worry about LeBlanc. Dennis is the last, that's our last problem. That's why the contracts got done right away.
He gets a motorcade. And this is very rookie. He doesn't even talk about it, probably. He just gets it.
Just gets it whisked.
Just gets it done. All right, good. So thanks to good. Steve Schindler and Midwest Big Bank day. For sponsoring hour two of always, as
roll
always,
call.
Early break. 464-5685. Call or text as always. I am curious. Today is a day that some celebrate and some procrastinate, which is tax day in
America.
Tax day.
I'm not talking about this.
My dad would celebrate saying this is the end of of 3.5 months of hell, of long days, 7 days a week.
So what will he do today? A hot cup of water with salt in it.
Yes.
That's what he enjoyed this morning.
What will we do today? He'll
drink coffee at 10 a.m., I'm sure. Oh, today is busy. He's wrapping things up. Okay, people are flying in to get their taxes done.
They're flying in?
I mean, they can still get an extension, obviously, which you're very aware of, Sip. Told us before on the airwaves.
I agree.
The extension type.
Yeah. My accountant's probably listening, and he's nodding his head.
Yep.
Now, wait a second. Do people fly in to see your dad?
Oh, they'll be busy. I mean, They'll be zooming at the airport right now.
Is there private jets everywhere coming to see your dad with a wad of receipts?
Yeah, they're flying. Yes, take it. The coach. I promise they're all there.
I have this folder.
It's where do I sign?
My question for you is this: at 464-5685, what is the best comparison to tax day in college football? Is there one that stands out to you, Bill, more than anything else?
I read through this last night and late last night while in bed, checked out the rundown, and it would probably compare mostly to probably signing day.
Signing day, that's what I
thought. And then also because signing day also is, it's not this and final, it goes on forever now, so you get the extension. And there's people committing all the time. It's not just signing day with the portal and with different times. And so the date's still good. But also, it is very much, it's so different than when there was just one first Wednesday in February. So back when it was like, this was like a hard date on a 15th. That's it, buddy. Now, because recruiting used to be so much fun back then. It's like, hey, first Wednesday in February, you're done. You're going to sign your class. You're gonna go to events that night. Mm-hmm. You're going to talk about the class, do all these things. Now there's two of them. Mm-hmm. The first one is the main one. Mm-hmm. But now that, imagine having
December.
So now there's a secondary tax day. Yeah. And then by the way, you can extend that.
Yeah.
And then also there's also times you can finish it in between.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of similarities to the recruiting part of it and how that is with the extension. Because anyone get an extension, all you gotta do is like that, just ask for it. They extend everybody. It's like, yeah, okay. That sounds good.
I hope so. The one thing though that would be, you don't want to skip your taxes and you don't want to skip recruiting. You gotta recruit.
No.
Yeah.
You gotta do it.
There is one thing that will, I remember I got fooled once with a phone call type of thing. There's a voice message of, this is the IRS that's reached out to you about something.
Yes.
And I get a hold of my tax lady. She goes, just so you know, the IRS does not just leave you a voice message.
Yeah, thank God. There's people trying to dupe people all over the nation.
All over the place. Yeah. You need to do this right away. And I'm like, whoa.
It scared the bejesus out of me one day.
The IRS is somewhat like the NCAA. Yeah. When they decide to show up, when they come on campus, it's like, now back in the day, when the NCAA still had some way more legs
teeth.
To it. Yeah, when the NCAA said, hey, we're gonna be there for a couple weeks checking things out, you were like, oh no. Mm. Oh no, what's going on? Same way, hey, the IRS, hey, we'd like to meet with you.
Yeah.
Bring your stuff in. We want to talk to you. Let's walk through some stuff.
Let's talk about something else.
So it's very much the same.
Can we talk about something else?
Tax day.
Uncomfortable. You're
uncomfortable with tax day.
Yeah.
So very, very similar to it, but a great day. Good job for your dad.
Well, he's one that's happy. He's one that's been through this for 3.5 months. For those like Sip, who likes to delay things. You're not alone. It's a very common thing that people that procrastinate tax day.
I love when you hear on the radio, if you've not paid your taxes in 10 years, get a hold of it. It's like,
that's amazing.
But here's my thing.
I don't know how you live with yourself.
Do you know anybody, though, that's been sent to jail? What happened? Didn't pay his taxes for 10 years. He's in jail. Never heard of it.
I haven't either.
Because the only way they get their money is to have you out there. They need the money. So putting you in jail is not going to get their money.
No.
So you never really hear about it.
No.
No, you don't ever hear
it. No, you don't. You don't. I got audited when I was like 21. It was crazy.
How'd that go for you?
I owed money.
How about
Bill's like, what?
21.
Yeah. 21.
IRS, where are you going to? That simple guy.
I got it. I got audited. No joke. It wasn't a huge deal. Thing. I had to pay it. I mean, I had to pay. I owed like $1,000.
The best is when you think about the taxes is at that age, you could do your taxes. Jake's dad could do your taxes 12 minutes. It was like this kind of hand. Here's the form.
Couldn't do it in 12 that. Minutes.
No, but it's not a major deal. I mean, no, to where not. Now where it's like, we have all like me and Laura have all these separate different things going. And now I have an independent contractor thing and all this.
It's quick and easy.
It's a lot. It's a lot.
You could probably figure it out, but it'd be hard.
You'd be surprised what I can't figure out. Just day to day.
What if I gave you a month?
No.
Maybe.
No. I couldn't pass Algebra 1 right now if I had to. I
none of us could probably. You had the Y. Is this Y and X?
Solve for X.
Come on. That's a good start. I think
you'd sell us a little short. If you gave me a proper amount of time,
I would still like to. If someone would like to finance, or if we could, we'd like to build the deck. I want to build the deck.
Us three.
I'd like to build a deck. Okay. An on-ground deck. We're not going out.
Take a deep breath.
I think, get us some tools.
Wait a second. An on-ground deck?
Yeah, that's something that just came out for your patio or something. I don't want to go. Are we ready to support weight? Are we ready to do that?
That might be the next project.
Maybe the next project.
But I think we could do it.
It'd be nice. Well, Jake will Google it.
Josh, I'll Google it.
Josh will Google it. Yep. And we'll start
putting this out.
That's what people are going to say.
We'll start putting some boards together.
See how this goes.
And I'll do some board. I'll do some board foot problems. Thank figure you. Out kind of what we need for supplies.
There'd be some
imagine us three.
You just built the fence long ago. I feel good about your chances of doing the deck here.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, you'd be. I think we could do
it. And aren't you pretty proud of that fence, too? You said it did a good job on it.
Yeah, I'm proud of it.
So I think you've got potential here.
Let's see a picture.
Please do. I'd like to see that fence.
Yeah, it's good. It worked. The deck thing is a good idea for us. I don't know how we do. The time would be the – I mean, you have incoming. We'd have to all figure out time.
Yes.
Because it's going to take us some time. It'd
be a May or June project, possibly.
Well, yeah, and we'd have to block out days.
I've got a tool belt. I've already got a belt. I got one. I do. Got it for Christmas. Very excited.
We have our bag from Bex. It could be a great bag from Bex. We got that.
Exactly.
We're covered. You're good for building that.
I think people would like lend us gear.
We could get our own gear. I'd just like to be
Where are we going to go? So we're going to get our own radial arm saw? Is that what we're going
to
do?
We're going to have to invest. There'll have to be some investment.
We drop $100,000 on the construction equipment.
We lost money on this. Quite a bit, actually.
We made $9,000 and it cost us $140.
It wasn't good business.
Jake's dad was crunching the numbers, it wouldn't be
and
good.
And our friendship
what
ended.
You guys doing? Yeah, friendship ended, too. Screw you.
It's a horrible deal.
It was terrible. It just a nightmare.
Imagine though, in the morning, we get to go over our plans. We meet at the Quiche restaurant. He's gonna go over the blueprints. Jake could get them out of a tube, and gonna unroll them and lay them out. Salt and pepper,
guys.
Here's what we're doing.
Here's the plan.
We're we got some 2x6.
We got quiche on the plans. You spilled on the plans over there. Before we get to break, look at Bill's hat, please. Sip. What does that say? Is that second rate or third rate? First rate ag. First rate ag and holders is a full service ag retailer offering everything from crop protection to lawn fertilizer. They've been around for 25 years in business. You can reach out at firstrateag.com or call 308-995-8327. Ask for Parker or Chris. And as always, please mention the ticket.
I got some photos from the guys this weekend. They were putting seed in the ground.
Did you seriously get photos?
I got photos of them. They're out there. Yeah, they're putting seed in there. They were doing that. And then they crop protection. Just because your crop's up doesn't mean we're good. It's not over. You got to protect the crop.
Could be hail.
Yeah, it could be a lot of things. I'm not sure if spraying anything on that will protect it from hail. I think that's one of those things we're going to fight.
Oh, and you're not talking about insurance protection. You're talking about real
protection. Real protection, yes.
Okay.
From
first ray ag.
From insects.
Oh.
Insects can get you.
Critters.
Yes. Okay. Or some sort of fungi.
Fun guy. Thank you to First Rate Ag as always. Again, please go to firstrateag.com or call 308-995-8327. We're going to do an early edition of Shut Up Simple because you got to leave early today.
Oh, yes.
You're not getting out of this.
Yeah, we're doing it right away.
Doing that next on Early Break on the Ticket.
You're listening to Early Break with Steve Sippel, Jake Sorensen, and Bill Busch on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Homeowners, are you tired of paying for a lawn care service when the results are leaving your lawn lifeless and full of weeds? Is your lawn sick of being ghosted by your service provider when they don't show up? Maybe it's time for a switch. At Weedman Lawn Care, excellent results, proactive communication, and superior customer care is what we're all about. Don't take my word for it. Check out our Google reviews. See the Weedman difference on your lawn. Go to weedman.com and get 50% off your first application with your program. Terms and conditions apply.
Unearth the secret to long-lasting tires at Tread's Central Tire Pros, a league apart in commitment, service, and expertise. This isn't just about rubber meeting the road, but trust, safety, and surety converging in perfect harmony. This is where expectations are exceeded every time. Make your appointment today at Tread's Central Tire Pros, just south of Cortland on Highway 77, or visit our website to explore our services. Remember, when it comes to tires, choose Tread's Central Tire Pros, because we tread differently.
Go Hog Wild Pit Barbecue. If the week's been too hectic to even think about dinner, or your family can't handle one more night of leftovers, then it's time to let Hog Wild do the cooking. Hog Wild's family packs are one heck of a good deal for a complete barbecue meal loaded with all the smoked meats, tasty sides, buns, and sauces you need to feed your family. Order online at GoHogWild.com. Hog Wild Pit Barbecue, 3210 Cornhusker Highway in Lincoln.
But don't be late, we close at 8.
At Fairway Meat Market, you're family, and as part of the family, they want to save you money on your meat and groceries. Now, through April 14th, enjoy USDA Choice Flat Iron Steaks for $9.99 per pound, all-natural boneless skinless chicken breast for $2.98 per pound, Duroc Pork Tenderloin for $3.99 per pound, and 4-ounce lobster tails for $6.99 each. That's all at Fairway Meat Market in the Rockledge Square Shopping Center, just south of 84th and Van Dorn.
What's the radon level at your home? Don't know? Find out with a call to Bryant Air Conditioning and Heating. Make sure your home is safe with a radon check from Bryant. If you've already tested, ask Bryant for a free estimate for mitigation. Once completed, you'll get a report showing how much safer your home is. When it comes to radon, call Bryant 467-1111 for testing and mitigation. Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing. We do whatever it takes.
Do you need motivation to get to the gym on the weekend or even in general? Tune into the Movement Hour each Saturday from 10 to 11 a.m. Movement Academy owner Robert Kuhlman will host the show as he introduces new ways to stay in shape. The Movement Hour, every Saturday morning from 10 to 11 a.m. on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox KFXL Weather. Brought to you by Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing.
Your Lincoln forecast for today, mainly sunny skies and breezy conditions to start off. Then a chance of showers and storms late. See a high around 83. Tonight, showers and storms likely, some of which could be severe. See a low near 63. And tomorrow, more showers, potentially storms likely, the high around 73. I'm meteorologist Kyle Collector for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Unearth the secret to long-lasting tires at Tread's Central Tire Pros, a league apart in commitment, service, and expertise. This isn't just about rubber meeting the road, but trust, safety, and surety converging in perfect harmony. This is where expectations are exceeded every time. Make your appointment today at Tread's Central Tire Pros, just south of Cortland on Highway 77, or visit our website to explore our services. Remember, when it comes to tires, choose Tread's Central Tire Pros, because we tread differently.
Hey Husker Nation, Matt Davison here with 1890. It's an exciting time to be a Husker fan, and to keep that momentum going, we need your help. Nebraska's always been a leader in college athletics, and we're doing the same through name, image, and likeness. NIL is a unique opportunity for every Husker fan to have a direct impact on the success of our programs. Through 1890, 100% of your contribution goes to the student athletes. So go to 1890nebraska.com, choose your sport, become a member, and help the Huskers recruit and retain the best. Go Big Red.
Biggest question people have is, how do I start the process? What is the process? I want to build a new home, but I don't know what the first step is.
Bob Benish is the founder and president of Aspen Builders, online at aspenbuildersinc.com.
The first step is make an appointment. Come on into my office. Let's sit around the table. Let's talk about what you're looking for, what your needs are, what your budget might be. And let's come up with some answers on what we're going to build, where we're going to build it, and what it's going to cost. So now is really the time to be contacting us to get an appointment to get the job done before school starts. Once you find a good lot, let's get it reserved because there's a very limited number of lots in this town. And then start designing that floor plan that's going to be perfect for you. Next thing you know, we're moving dirt.
Make your dream home a reality and call Aspen Builders at 423-6811. Online at AspenBuildersInc.com. Your home is waiting at Aspen Builders.
Hi, it's Joel Norman, the voice of your Lincoln Stars hockey team. Tune in to 93.7 The Ticket every Tuesday night from 8 to 9 p.m. to hear the latest on the Stars with myself, head coach Rocky Russo, and special player guests.
This, I'm not on drugs, I'm not drunk,
is Early Break with Sip and Jay, brought to you by Gaina Trucking. Weekday mornings from 6 to 8 on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
We'll get to the game show here in 1 second, but during the break, Josh came in here and tried to say the Eagles were the same sound as Tom Petty. This is Tom Petty right here.
Josh, he took it to the air.
Yeah. Do the Eagles sound like Tom Petty to you, Bill?
To me, it's a hard no.
It's a hard no for me and Sip also.
It's a hard no.
That's 0 for 3 here. Yeah. For this one. 3 for 3 on a no on that one.
Heyman. I'd like Heyman to chime in. Yeah.
Rick Heyman, any comparison of Tom Petty and the Eagles? We all say no here in the studio.
Check Wikipedia.
Do they compare Tom Petty to the Eagles? All right, we're going to start.
Leaving if he keeps this up.
You are leaving here shortly.
On a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again.
Well, we're gonna do an early edition
Bill's
of.
Been out of control today. He got recharged in Utah.
He did get recharged.
He's been out of control.
I like it. I met my spirit animal
at the airport.
At
the Starbucks in the airport, right?
He's been low key out of control.
It's good. It's a good key to pee in. Yeah. It's fine.
It's a good key.
It's a good key to
pee in. What key is that? Low.
Well, you got to leave early today, yeah. Sip. But you're not getting out of the game show
good
today.
Good God, let's go.
We're doing an early version of Shut Up, Sip. Please call us right now.
Call
464-5685. Your chance to win a business box of bagels to Bagels and Joe. He was 1-4 last week.
What?
He had no lifeline. He had no lifeline to help him out. One in four.
It wasn't as bad as it sounds.
Today, because we had the Masters this weekend, we got golf terms today for Shut Up Sipple. Golf terminology.
Yeah, Bill will be good at this.
Bill will be very helpful
in
this.
Golf terms?
Golf terms.
I delve into that hard.
I think we will get at least three of the four correct here today.
Okay.
Of everybody, you and the listener.
Right, Mulligan.
So, that is not one of the answers, but there you have the right thinking there.
What if at the Master you could buy mulligans for your
start?
That'd
be awesome.
Hey, how much are they? They're $5,000 a piece.
I'll take seven.
I'll take seven mulligans.
I need them all.
It would be so much more fun.
It would be pretty
fun. Scheffler's got two mulligans.
All of a sudden, Scheffler's using his mulligan.
That would be so much better.
He's got two left still.
He's two left.
Kind of fun. That'd be kind of fun.
All right, here we go. 464-5685. Shut Up Sipple starts right now.
We've all been there. You're listening to the radio, and then that rage starts to grow inside of you. It starts to consume you. It gets to a point where you just want to yell, "Shut up, Sipple!"
No, sorry. I'm sorry. Well, here's your chance. It's time to shut up, Sipple. Call now to play. 464-5685. Shut up, Sipple. Brought to you by Bagels and Joe.
If you are confused, we're playing this earlier because Sip has to bolt here in a couple minutes. So, again, golf terms is the topic today in Shut Up, Sipple. You guys feel okay about this. Bill, maybe not so much.
Not so much. I'll know a couple of them.
Okay. Elion. Elion's our caller. How do you feel about golf terms today, Elion?
I'm on the school golf team. So,
he's on the golf team. You guys are screwed. He's on the golf team right now.
Yeah, we're done.
We'll see how this goes.
The guy from the golf team calls in.
I know.
It's amazing. Elion called.
Bill is a lifeline for Sip for one question. Elion, first question goes to you. What is the other word for a double eagle in golf?
An albatross.
Brilliant.
It is an albatross. 1-0. Would you guys have that one?
No. Good God.
The big bird, albatross.
Okay, the big bird.
Yes. Albatross. Okay. All right, Sip, Bill's in play here. 1-0 lead for Elion. What is a club that has 60-degree loft or more usually called? What is that club called? 60-degree loft or more.
Well, it's one of two things, obviously.
Is it? It's two options?
Hold it. Hold it. Yeah, that could be. Well, it's either. Hang on.
Can we consult?
Yeah.
Sure. Well, if you're going to use them, I guess. 60-degree loft or more is defined as this. 5 seconds, if you'd like to take this one.
He's writing a sentence.
I see that. I don't like where this is going with that.
Just use the word you said. It's like that. Use the word.
Five.
And I think your word sums it up.
Four.
Okay, sand wedge. It seems too simple.
That'd be more of a 56 degree. This is a 60 degree. What you want this one, Elion, or not?
Yeah, sure. I'll take it. Is it a pitching wedge?
Also wrong.
Oh, interesting.
That would be a lob wedge.
Lob wedge.
Pitching wedge is actually lower loft than a sand wedge. That was closer than pitching
You're
wedge.
You're going to have to have Bill finish this.
Hang on. Okay. Elion, back to you. 0-0 tie. What does the acronym GIR mean in golf?
GIR.
This is for Elion.
GIR.
Yeah. GIR. 5 seconds. Five.
Get it right.
No.
Oh.
Not get it right. Yes. Are you passing or not?
Passing.
Green in regulations.
Well, I got that.
For the win, 0-0 tie because he went for the steal and got it wrong. What device is used to test the speed of the greens on a golf course?
Ooh, I should know that. This will not shock me when we miss it.
We miss it. Confident there. 5 seconds.
It's a device.
Five.
It's a device.
Four.
A device. I don't know what it is.
Greenometer.
I'll be mad at this.
Elion, do you want this one for the win or you want to go the tiebreaker?
Let's get a tiebreaker.
Stimp meter. Stimp meter is what it's called.
I don't know. Never mind.
All right, this is for Elion to go, and you guys go over under, and we'll get stimp out.
Remember,
Elion,
you're on the golf team.
In what year was the stimp meter first used at a PGA event to measure green speed? Elion, I need a year.
In what year was the what?
The stimp meter first used.
'93.
Before or after 1993?
Before that.
Brilliant! Winner!
1976 and Smith has got to go.
1-0. Write it down.
1-0. It wasn't guys, pretty.
Thanks. Good job, Bill.
Thanks.
All right.
Good show today.
We'll see you tomorrow, maybe, if I'm here. But that's a win. All right. Good job, Elion. Good try. We'll get you a big one of coffee calling down the road.
Thanks, Elion.
All right. Thank you.
Appreciate
Bye.
You.
Bye.
You know, it wasn't pretty, but we kind of thought that one might be the case going into that one.
Well, I thought the guy that was on the golf team would have a better shot at some of those.
He seemed very kind. He got the
I will say this for Elion, though. That was not easy. They were not easy.
He got Albatross.
Yeah.
He wouldn't have had Albatross.
Let me ask you this. Why is when people say it's Albatross around my neck? It's like it's a negative. People say that.
You never heard that before.
You never heard
No.
It's like an Albatross around. Oh, yeah. That's a term.
Is that a term?
Right. Ask the Breakers. That's a term.
Albatross around my neck. I've never heard that in my whole life.
Yes. That's a term.
It's a negative connotation.
It's like being weighed down. It's like you're holding me back type of thing. Check that, Breakers.
I got to say, I've never heard
that. I think I'm right
term.
On that.
And if you're right, then no one's ever said it to me before. Mm-hmm. I've never heard that one before. But, nice. You know, it's okay. Before we get to break, saw this over the weekend, Bill, that Kentucky's got a new head coach in basketball. It is not Billy Donovan. It is not Scott Drew. It's Mark Pope. Mark Pope from BYU comes. He was there with the Cougars for 5 years, and he's now he was formerly on the Kentucky basketball team back in the late 90s.
96, he was on the national championship team. When they came in to be announced yesterday, they sold out Rupp Arena.
I saw that.
They sold out Rupp Arena. They came in, they being the 96 championship team with Pope, came in on a bus into the arena. The 96 team got off, and Pope was the last one off with the trophy. And he talked about that we embrace championships.
Yes.
We embrace talking about championships here. So that was a lot of fun. They sold out Rupp Arena, which does state also that I heard that someone was talking about that. Very clear that they're not heartbroken over the loss of Calipari. That's kind of with the take on this. He's a Rick Pitino guy.
Yes, And Patino vouched his support for him. Yes. He had a video put out there, said this is a great hire for Kentucky. Obviously a former Wildcat, very happy to be the head coach. And so you have someone that it means a lot for them to be there because he's an alumni of Kentucky. So I know it's not the most popular hire with that fan base. They wanted a splash like Scott Drew, who is a national champion head coach at Baylor. But this
I
is somebody
I think they did pretty good. I think the splash is pretty good. I think the fan base, when they've sold it out, that tells you right there. That's a big deal. So I think it's a great hire.
Those who will push back will say in 5 years he never won a tournament game at BYU. Two appearances in 5 years. Again, the first year he was there was the COVID year, so they couldn't even go to the dance that year because of COVID. But two appearances in 5 years, never won a game. But again, Kentucky background, I don't think it's a horrible hire for Kentucky.
I think it's a great hire.
And you're right. The whole scene was very cool yesterday with getting off the bus and he's the last one there.
I like it. And then they said the fan base, the support of it. I think it's a really good hire. I mean, yes, maybe a Scott Drew, maybe a couple of people that were involved with that, but I think they still nailed it.
Yeah, I wonder if the fans, if you had to choose between Billy Donovan, which is the name after Scott Drew, or Mark Pope, who would you want? Now, Donovan obviously was very successful, two titles in a row at Florida, but he's been out of the game for a while. He's been NBA for 10 years or so?
At least 10 years. I think I'd have a hard – I think they got the right person. I think they got the right person. And so it'll be fun to see. Everything is amped up a lot, obviously.
Yes.
When you get to Kentucky, hang on. Yeah, that's a lot right there.
Mark Pope, the new head coach in Lexington, Kentucky for the Wildcats. And we'll see how that tenure goes. When we come back, the spillover on Early Break on the Ticket.
Listening to Early Break with Steve Sippel, Jake Sorensen, and Bill Busch on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Looking for a job that feels like family? Join Lincoln Industries, where tradition meets innovation. They're a family-owned, privately held manufacturing company with a passion for excellence and a commitment to their community. They have openings on all shifts at both the main plant and airpark facilities, offering flexibility to fit your schedule. Whether you're a seasoned professional or just starting out, there's a place for you there. At Lincoln Industries, they invest in their people's success, providing opportunities for growth and advancement. Apply now and become a part of something special at Lincoln Industries.
Spring is a time of new beginnings and trying new things. If you haven't tried Fira's cheese spread yet, the time is now. For parties for St. Patrick's Day and Easter, or celebrating the NCAA tournament with friends, there's no better dip to bring everyone together and celebrate something from Nebraska. Get to your local grocery store today and load up on Fira's cheese spread. No event or party is complete without it on your table.
Plains Cover Crop is your one-stop seed shop. Call us now for spring and summer forages, CRP mixes, and fall cover crop blends. We do farm-specific consulting for practical and efficient seed blends to fit your geography and goals. With a very diverse inventory, we will tailor a blend just for you. We're also looking for contract growers, and we buy and sell rye. Find us online at plainscovercrop.com. Timeless agronomy practices paired with modern technology. East Highway 20 in Orchard and across Nebraska.
Gaina Trucking is hiring CDL Class A and B drivers. Gaina Trucking guarantees a 40-hour work week year-round, and their strong team culture makes it not a job, but a career. Gaina Trucking offers health, vision, and dental insurance, 401k with company match, an employee assistance program, and other bonus programs. Build a better career today with great team culture at Gaina Trucking. Learn more and apply today at GainaTrucking.com.
Constructors is now hiring for all positions, with laborers starting at $23 and up based on experience. Constructors has immediate job openings for laborers, mechanics, bridge builders, operators, and drivers. Start your new career today. Constructors offers great pay, health, dental, and vision insurance, paid time off, paid holidays, and so much more. Join the crew today and be a part of Nebraska's oldest paving company dating back to 1908. For a complete list of openings and to apply online, visit ConstructorsLincoln.com.
Hi, it's Joel Norman, the voice of your Lincoln Stars hockey team. Tune in to 93.7 The Ticket every Tuesday night from 8 to 9 p.m. to hear the latest on the Stars with myself, head coach Rocky Russo, and special player guests.
Jake Sorensen here for The Body Shop. My wife is nearing her due date with our first child and has been in need of a good massage as her body continues to change and adapt. Dennis and the team at The Body Shop were incredible with the prenatal massage that she's still talking about today.
I was also able to get a deep tissue massage, so it was a great bonding experience and a unique couples massage in general. If you're in need of stress relief, book a massage today at thebodyshoplincoln.com. The Body Shop at 48th and A.
Birch Merch is your one-stop shop for all your printing and promotional needs in Lincoln, Nebraska. They specialize in screen printing, embroidery, vehicle wraps, window wraps, print collateral, promotional products, and signage. At Birch Merch, they are committed to delivering high-quality products and exceptional customer service. Their experienced team of designers and printing professionals will work with you every step of the way to ensure that your vision is realized. Call for a quote today at 402-217-5212 or go to perch-merch.com.
Hi, Sean Callahan here for Copple Chevrolet GMC, and our annual spring sales event is now underway. We have absolutely huge savings right now at Copple. New Sierras and new Silverados have a double whammy. Choose from APR starting at 1.9% or discounts over $9,000. Yes, that's right, 1.9% APR or discounts of over $9,000. So please take that short money-saving drive down 144th Street just south of the interstate or check us out online at copplecars.com. You'll be glad you did. All deals with approved credit.
The More Coffee and Tea, formerly with only 4 Lincoln locations. Guess what?
What?
There's 5 Lincoln locations now.
Oh my gosh.
That's 25% more Lincoln locations than there used to be. Can you even imagine a world where there's only 4 Lincoln Mill locations? Feels like ages ago. We were all so young then. The Mill on 11th, located right alongside 93.7 The Ticket Studios, 1040 O Street.
Spring often marks the beginning of severe weather, which can lead to power outages. LES wants you to be prepared before the storm. Restock your emergency kit, update your info with LES, and if you encounter an outage, report it at les.com/report.
Okay, it's time to sell the house. How do we even begin to choose from the hundreds of realtors in town?
Easy, we make a pros list.
You mean a pros and cons list?
No, just a pros list. We need someone with pro photography to showcase the house in the best possible way, pro marketing to make sure we get maximum exposure, pro negotiations so we know we get the best price.
This is one of those times where you already know the right answer, isn't it?
You know it is. Ben Blecker and Professional Realty Group.
Contact Ben Blecker and the team at Professional Realty Group of Berkshire Hathaway's Home Services Ambassador online at prg-ne.com.
This is Lincoln's home for sports talk on the FM dial. Also online at theticketfm.com.
On the internet.
KNTK FM Firth. 93.7 The Ticket.
We're on the air.
Back.
Well, party's starting early today, isn't it?
To more of Early Break with Sip and Jake.
Simple, you are an idiot.
Brought to you by Gaina Trucking. On 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
It is time for the spillover. Chris Rapp joins us. Bill Busch sticking around. Sip had to leave for an interview of some capacity. I'm not really sure what he's, who he's talking to.
Sounded odd.
He gave us no insight of who he was talking to at all. Very sketchy.
Everybody's interviewing for their job.
Could be. You never
all of
know.
A sudden, is he talking to another radio station?
He wouldn't dare. He wouldn't dare.
What if he was? What if he got a later the interview? All of a sudden, he's.
Yeah, I'm leaving, guys. Where are you going? Alabama. You're leaving. You're moving states, too.
What if he just changed in state? All of a sudden, he's just on a different station.
It'd be terrible.
Yeah.
Come on. If he wouldn't do that to us.
I don't think so.
Wouldn't do, by the way, so we mentioned during the game show.
Yes, there was confusion, and I stuck with
there's it. There's a phrase here, albatross around the neck. I did not know about this. I thought you were pulling my leg here a little bit here.
Where's it go back to?
So, per several texts, which I'm going to trust here because people are all on the same page here. People have said that this albatross around the neck was a curse to spend eternity sailing with an albatross around the neck, but somebody shot an albatross and it stopped the wind apparently while they were sailing. So it is basically a curse. It's a bad thing.
It's a curse.
I've never heard that before though. Never heard that before. You taught me something. Someone that said it went back to the days of Homer in the Odyssey. Yeah, yeah. I don't know if it went that far.
I think it did. That's why I remember reading that.
John and Lincoln says, okay, he goes further. He says, albatross around the neck comes from a book written in the 1800s about the sailor that shoots an albatross that was supposedly good luck, and the crew makes him wear it around the neck for penance. Penance.
That's where I am. Just trying to help. I'm trying to educate people.
I've never heard this before. So thank you for that, Bill. I had no idea. I asked Raph when he walked in how much of the Masters he watched, and you said how much, Raph?
Other than Tiger's first hole, I watched every single hole after that.
And this is Thursday he's talking about. So Thursday. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, watched everything.
I was exhausted last night. I think I went to bed at like 7.
Are you talking about you watched the actual TV broadcast or the stuff before that was like on Masters.com?
Started watching on ESPN.com, watching the
Bill, groups. this is like yesterday probably at
and
least
I had watched eight. Nothing until yesterday.
Right.
Nothing. Hadn't seen
you the upset stroke. About that though. You called me and said you'd wish you'd watch some of it.
I called Jake on my drive back to Lincoln, late afternoon, early evening on Saturday.
Yes.
And let Jake know that I was upset. I didn't get a chance to see anything. I'd like to have watched some of that.
It made me happy to hear that.
Now, I did
upset.
Watch some of the replay that night. Saturday, I got home Saturday night. It was on the Golf Channel or something it was on. So I got to see a little bit that night.
Okay.
Some idea what's going on. But I missed it.
I was just happy to hear that you seem genuinely disappointed you had to watch it. I can tell some sarcasm once in a while.
Yeah. I wish the weather was worse here.
Here.
I'd like to have seen the weather much worse here. Like to have it raining and miserable. So you're happy to watch.
Yeah.
It was a tough to watch, and it was so nice out yesterday.
Well, I would say it was like 90 degrees, so you didn't feel horrible about not being out there.
It was ridiculously hot. When I got off the plane to walk to my – I was on the rooftop at the airport at Omaha. I'm like – it was like a hairdryer on my face. It was – I get in the car, it's 92 degrees. Then yesterday we're outside doing some stuff. I was like, I'm not ready for this. I'm not built for full summer here in April. I wasn't happy.
No, I think I saw like 85 today, and it gets out like to 55 on Wednesday or Thursday. So you're getting back to spring this week.
We need that rain.
Quick summer.
We need thunder and lightning. Bad.
Tonight, as I said, maybe some hail tonight, which I don't really. You said you would be okay with hail, at least small, non-damaging hail.
Non-damaging hail, and I want a foot of it.
A foot of non-damaging hail sounds interesting to me. Yeah. Please. And you don't ask for much. You don't ask for much.
Not much at all.
Just some rain, some thunder, and some non-damaging a foot of hail.
It'll melt slower so we don't get any runoff. That's for the mushroom hunting.
Mushroom hunting, yeah. Okay. That's going to be – that's coming up. So for those who are, again, have never done that before, Bill, what is the appropriate time for morel mushroom hunting?
Well, really, it started probably about 2 or 3 days ago. Based off the weather, but here's what you want to look for: are the lilac bushes blooming? When the lilac bushes bloom, that's when the ground temperature has hit for the mushrooms to grow, and that's 100% accurate. That's what you want to judge things off of. And then it starts by terrain, which means right now you want to do well in the river bottoms in the lower levels like that. Then they'll move up into the hills as time moves along. But right now we're looking at lower riverbed area along the Missouri, the Elkhorn, any rivers, any creeks. That's where it's going to be right now.
In your experience, morel mushroom hunting in the past, have you seen others in the same areas doing the same thing as you, or have you been by yourself typically?
Oh, you'll see others. There's certain areas.
Other groups out there.
Yeah. It's become kind of a fad here recently. It's kind of a big deal.
Are they happy to see you or pissed to see you?
Not really. Not really. It's kind of happy. They're kind of happy to see you. Yeah.
Oh, you're in the school.
Yeah,
it's kind of like a club, basically.
But what gets you the most is also if you see someone else, like, how you doing? You don't have any. And they got like a lot. You're like going, okay. You're encouraged because they found some, but then you're also a little bit embarrassed. A little embarrassed.
Yeah, mine's in the backpack. You just can't see it. They're in there. Just trust me on this one. So. Well, good luck to you and your upcoming ventures to morel mushroom hunting. Maybe someday I'll join along, but I'm not sure this is the year.
You could do it right now because, Jake, you have not had a baby yet.
No, this could be the day, though. My wife would prefer that today's the day, not wait any longer.
Elizabeth.
When you get past your due date, you'll get a little cranky.
Well, she's a little owly right now, you said.
Understood.
Just miserable?
That the big thing? Disappointed, not a little bit, not sad, but it's like, come on, I'm ready to have this baby and start, the next stage of life here instead of just continuing to carry it.
Expand within.
Right. Yes. Right. There's not necessary. Yeah. The baby's at a good weight here. It's healthy. So we'll see how this goes. But I might be back tomorrow. Yeah. I might not. We'll see how the day goes. If there's no baby, I'll be back tomorrow.
Nice.
If there is, I'd
like to
be.
See you.
I'll be here if it's possible. That's it for us. The Drive with Raf AD and Amon Green is next for Steve Sippel and Bill Busch. I am Jake Sorensen. We will see you tomorrow.
This is Lancaster County Attorney Pat Condon reminding you to vote for my friend and colleague, Carolyn Bozen. Carolyn Bozen is a strong voice.